Wow. What have we created? Who knows? Hello, it's Sunday evening. So this is ever so slightly weird, being back here on a Sunday evening. But it should be fun. For the next 3 hours, we're going to take your call straight to air. No screening. Agent Chris is in the studio with me. Hello, Agent Chris.
Hi.
There we go. See, that's weird, having you in here. As it is. So there's no one filtering the calls. We have Gary behind the glass. Good evening, Gary. Hope you're well, sir. Don't know what that salute's supposed to imply. We'll discuss your politics later. It's a wave. It's a wave. 0870-9090-973. Now, listen, we don't know if this is going to work. We don't know if this is going to sustain 3 hours. But your call's going to come straight to air. You can kind of do what you want to. There are various rules. I'm just going to get a little buzz. And these are my favourite headphones. I hope that's, there we go. Oh, no, don't tell me my favourite headphones are dying on me.
Really?
That would be a shame. Your calls are going to go straight to air. We're a little bit anxious, a little bit nervous. It could be Pony, it could be Brilliant. We've not done this before. Tommy Boyd did this a long time ago. I think we should salute Tommy Boyd for his Human Zoo, of which this is, of course, is a rip-off. Clive Ball, Bob's Tea Break, we salute you, sir. And we just go in, shall we? Shall we just pick
go,
a line?
Just
let's,
go for it.
Let's go 1 to 10, first of all, and see what happens. Let's go, line 1, you're on the wireless.
Bukaki.
Yes, bukkake, of course, is the ancient Japanese art of tying a woman up. And then, you know what that means, don't you? It's very rude.
I did not know that. Oh, really?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
I have mined the act.
Wow.
Yes, seriously, it's a specialist thing. Well, that's a good start. We're potentially in some form of social. We go to line 2, shall we? Let's see. Line 2, you're on the wireless. Anything else? No, that's it. Well, we've had our first move. 6 minutes into the show, we've had our first move. I'm hoping we'll get something with a bit of substance.
Hopefully. Fingers crossed.
Here's the thing. We literally... I'll tell you a minute. Let's go to line 3 first. Line 3, you're on the wireless.
Ian, my old mate, how are you?
I'm very well, mate. How are you?
Ian, I couldn't wait. I was thinking all day waiting for your show to start at 10. You're going to be responsible for a lot of people getting into work late tomorrow.
That's the plan. Including myself and Agent Chris will be coming in late tomorrow, hopefully.
Yeah, but you haven't got, like, real jobs, have you, really?
What do you mean I haven't got a real job?
Well, come on, Ian, you know, 3 or 4 hours a day on the radio, chatting rubbish, you know what I mean?
Oh, yeah, it's not digging a hole, is it?
To be fair, it's not real work, is it, you know?
No, but guess what? I still get paid for this. I get paid probably stack loads more than anyone else.
Yes, that's what I mean,
it's
you
great.
Know? I mean, quite fortunate, really, because, you know, you're a bit of a tin ribs, aren't you, Ian, really?
A tin ribs?
Tin ribs, you know, you're a bit sort of gangly and...
Well, I'm gangly, but I'm not as skinny as I used to be, mate. I'm kind of filling out a little bit. We just had an excellent Domino's pizza, and I've had some potato wedges, and I've got... Chris, look at my belly.
Ian, it's all that chocolate you eat on the show.
I know, it's bad. I was at the gym... my chest is... What's your name, sorry?
Danny.
My chest is really hurting.
Is it?
That's a bad thing to happen, isn't it? A painful chest.
Tightening chest is not good.
It's probably just a heart attack or something.
In that case, it's fine. We can carry on. yes?
You've got a bit of a fan base on the AOL.
The AOL?
The ARL.
What's the ARL?
Well, it's, if you go www.
Oh, we've got our first website. Is this like MySpace? Because I'm kind of addicted to MySpace now.
I do like MySpace, but it's not really. It's the online pub, they call it.
Oh, yeah, yes, I've heard of this.
I'll send it to you, Ian.
You send it to me?
Yeah.
Shall I give out the email address? It's ian@lbc.co.uk, in case anyone wants to email. No one's bloody bothered. Anything else, my friend?
I like the facial hair as well.
Oh, that's gone now.
You got rid of the face fuzz?
I've got the sideburns, but I haven't got the beard anymore.
Mm.
I've just been to the loo, and I've just decided that I need to get a haircut.
You know, what was it, a Tom Tit or a Jimmy?
It was just a Jimmy, although I do need a number 2, definitely. Yes.
Yeah, I mean, I'm still cautious. I know it's the late show, but I think unnecessary swearing is sort of wrong, you know?
No, exactly. We don't encourage swearing, but it's...
I mean, what about the word bum?
You can say bum.
What about prat?
You can say Pratt.
All right, good.
I do have a dump button here, right in front of me. Now, so.
I bet your finger's over here right now.
It's very, very close, yeah. I've got really bad indigestion. This is the same problem we had when we used to do the weekend show. Of just wolfing down pizza. Wolfing down pizza.
Do you know what you need?
Yes, what?
Rennie Rapees.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's really worked, actually.
Well, I haven't got any. I'm in a flipping studio at 10 past 10.
You're the celebrity. You're the talent, my friend. Get Agent Chris down that pharmacist right now.
Well, we're in the middle of this really rough estate. There's no, Chris, go to a pharmacist now.
I can't, I'm too full.
Chris is full as well.
Ian, if he wants his 10% or whatever, he better go.
Yeah, his 10%? Jeez, that's not how it works.
Anyway, Ian. Yes.
Hello.
Much love, my friend.
Bless you.
I'll be listening, all right?
Bless you. So fingers crossed it gets better than this.
Yeah, cheers, mate.
Cheers, bye-bye. There we go.
Wow, 9 minutes in.
And it's still not got interesting. Well, at least we... No, what was good there was we had a conversation with someone.
Yes.
He didn't just put the phone down and run out and, is Gary listening to another station through there? He's tapping away as though he's listening to...
TalkSport.
TalkSport. Oh, well, good evening to everyone who's just joined us from TalkSport, because George Galloway has finished. Mike Stickin has just started prattling on about parking tickets. What would be great is if someone could call us up and play a bit of TalkSport down the phone. We could hear what Mike Stickin is banging on about, if you want to do that. The phone... I'll give out the phone number in a bit. I've not really had any need to so far. We're going through the numbers. I have to go to line three. I apologise to London. Line three, you're on the wireless.
Hi, Ian.
Hello, line three.
I'm with Jesse from Stratford.
Oh, I just heard you on the Best of Clive Bull.
I know, I heard myself on it. I thought I was quite good, actually. I liked myself on the radio there.
Did you?
Yeah. Ian, what's going on?
I don't know what's going on in your world.
No, I never do in yours. The reason I called in was, you know, I spoke to you last... I think I spoke to you before and about playing some Indian music.
Whatever.
Yeah, I'm not sure if this is going to work. I've taped some. I'm going to see if I can play it.
Right? Oh, wicked, lovely. Thank you, Yasser.
Can you just give me a second and go to another corner and then I can get it ready?
Well, no, I don't have the technology to do that.
All right, I don't know if this is...
All right, well, how long have I got to wait?
It was a few seconds.
All right, well, then we can wait.
I just need to put the volume up right and then...
Okay.
Well, how long have I got to wait?
Okay. Just hang on a second, it's coming. Sorry. So let me put this out again. I was working a minute ago.
08709090973 if you want to call. All your calls tonight, the next 3 hours, are going straight to air.
Oh, it's not... Sorry. Something messed up with the aerial. God.
He's had a whole day to prepare.
Oh, it's got... Oh, God, my ear was messed up. Flipping egg. This wasn't supposed to happen. Let me try again.
Okay.
This wasn't supposed to happen.
As Chris says, Yasser, you've had a whole day to prepare for this.
Okay. Listen, about a couple of minutes, let me try again, all right? If this doesn't work, then I'll have to hang up.
Okay, well, okay.
Can you hear that?
No, Yasser. Do you want to call us back a little bit later on?
What?
Do you want to call us back a little bit later? You go off and sort it all out.
Yeah, all right, then.
All right.
I thought it was going to work. I'll have to phone again later.
Okay, you phone again later.
All right, then.
Thanks, Yasser. Bye. There we go. We're letting everyone put their phone down as well, which I think is nice.
Brilliant.
Let's go straight to line 4. I'll explain what we're doing after quarter past. Let's just go... We're going through the 10 lines. Line 4, you're on the wireless.
Hi, Ian.
Yes?
My name's Colin. I'm busy driving around in Dorking now, and I'm a Domino's delivery guy.
Oh, you're not the guy that delivered just now, are you?
No, I'm down in Dorking.
Oh, you're in Dorking, okay.
Yeah, I'm busy on the way to go drop off a pizza, a Mighty Meaty.
Okay. I had a Vegarama.
No, I don't like Vegaramas.
Oh, they're good, mate. Domino's is the best the potato wedges are amazing.
I know, that's what I usually take for my staff meal.
What I want to ask you...
Yeah?
The little garlic and herb pots.
Yeah.
Why are they so small? Come on.
I don't know. I get asked that a lot of times when I drop off by people.
Because Chris wanted my one and I told him to get stuffed because it was mine.
Yeah. No, they always ask for extras.
Yes.
We're not supposed to give them extras, but we do it.
But you can give extras. You have the ability to slip one under the counter, do you?
Yeah, sometimes.
Okay, that's very good.
Off the air, we're allowed to sometimes.
But on the air, not allowed to?
No.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. What would you like to say?
No, I just wanted... I heard you saying that you just had a Domino's. I thought, oh, well, isn't that quite nice? Because I'm busy working tonight. I'm finishing in about half an hour.
It is very nice.
Yeah.
That's made me very windy, Pops.
Ah, okay.
Okay.
All right. Thank you very much for buying Domino's.
And, hey, listen, thank you very much for delivering Domino's.
Thank you. We don't usually get to thank you from the clients.
Well, I'm thanking you. And I gave the chap, it was £30 and 40 pence. I gave him £32. There's a tip of £1.60. Is that acceptable?
That's very acceptable. Some people... They want their change back to the P. Like, if it's $12.99, they want their one penny back. If it's, like, pinned 89 there once 11 p back.
Wow, that's just
really.
Yeah, that's incredible. I used to be like that. I never used to tip the pizza guy because you know you get paid a good wage.
No, we only really work for
the love of pizzas.
Yeah, yeah. Yes, that's what we do.
Okay.
Right. Thank you very much.
God bless you.
I'm turning into the guy's drive now, so.
Okay, you better go. You better go.
All right.
Bye bye.
Bye bye. Thank you.
Okay, so this is, hopefully it's going to be a permanent thing. Someone's just emailed in. We're going to do it for a few months and see if it naturally runs its course. It's 3 hours of Triple M, which is what we do at the last 30 minutes on the weekday show. It's where we take your calls straight to air. There's no screen. And Chris is in the studio with me.
Hello.
I feel like, I mean, maybe I'll interview you later on. Maybe we'll do an interview. If we get no calls, which is possible, I'll interview you about your things I'll be asking.
Yep.
Did you always want to be in radio?
Nope.
Well, don't tell the answer now. This is if we get desperate, of course. Did you always want to be in radio? Did you used to watch me on the 11 o'clock show? And what's your dream job? And those are the three things I'll be asking if we interview you later on. So your calls are going to come straight there. Oh, and Konstantin Jupp, what a great name, has emailed in. Yay for Chris talking. He's a funny guy, and you two can play off each other well. Keep up the good work, guys. Jack, let me do some of these emails. Sorry, I'm going to be belching a bit, but it doesn't matter. Can you ask people if they know where to get a mini fridge that is less than £20 and is quiet and can fit bottles in? That's from Jack Day. Helen says, we'll do that later. Hang on a second. Oh, and Lino sent in, a picture of a nun showing us her vagina. So that's good. So things have kicked off to a good start. He really has. She's a bit rough though. 08709090973. Where did we get to? We did line four, didn't we?
Line five, I think.
So right. Line five is next. Line five, you're on the wireless.
Hello, Mr. Lee.
It's Chavvy Vicky.
Hello.
Hello, love. How are you?
Thought I'd get my call in early.
I suspect, this is how I suspect it's going to work, is that the first hour we're going to get a lot of calls. Between 11 and 12:30, it's going to be really quiet. Then the last half hour it'll kick off again. But I don't know. And we've literally planned nothing. Chris is reading a newspaper, but it's a newspaper from... What's the date on that paper, Chris?
April the 23rd.
April the 23rd.
Was it a good day?
Well, Frank Bruno is in, Bruno Baby Love Split. Don't laugh at that.
Sorry.
But we thought we'll have a pile of papers in here, so if it goes quiet, we can go, oh, look, McCartney's had a row with, what's-her-face. You know,
yeah,
whatever.
That one.
But,
yeah.
I do like the Sunday papers, they're full of,
You get free DVDs in them.
You do, but they're all rubbish.
Rubbish. Uh-huh. Why
would I want to see Splash?
Well, I don't know.
No, yes.
You like mermaids?
No, I don't like mermaids. Mermaids are supposed to be sexy, but what's sexy about a woman who's half a fish?
Well, I don't know.
Gills are not sexy.
Gills are not sexy.
Unless they're on Kevin Costner in Waterworld.
Well, I don't think Kevin Costner's all that either, really.
No, yes, you do.
No, I don't.
Okay.
No. So, anyway, no, I just thought I'd get my call in early.
Okay. Do you want to say anything?
Hello.
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 Lovely.
MySpace is great, by the way.
Oh, no, you've been on the MySpace as well,
haven't
you? I'm
loving it.
Let me give out the two addresses. The two addresses. And look, Chris, how many friends have you got on MySpace?
99.
He's got 99. I've got about 172, so I'm winning. but it's myspace.com/TheRealIanLee or /TheRealAgentChris. And we're going to have a competition to see who gets the most. Can I say, there are a lot of hot women on MySpace.
But are you sure that they're real?
No.
Yeah,
well, some of them have pictures of themselves on there. So that's got to be real.
There's some cute men in there as well.
Is it full of cute men?
Well, there seem to be quite a few cute men.
It's very addictive. It's very
Yeah, I've got another message. Just as we're talking, I don't know if you heard that, but I've got another message from MySpace.
I think you made it up.
No, I haven't made it up.
Okay.
Yeah, no, but I've got 21 friends, and I joined 2 days ago, which I think is pretty good going.
I've got 172, and I joined 2 days ago.
Well, if I give mine out, then I'll see how many more I get.
Do you want to, though?
Yeah.
Go on, then.
Okay, it's MySpace/ChavvyVicky.
Well, you missed up the .com, but yes.
Yeah, you know what I mean.
Chavvy. And how are you spelling Chavvy and Vicky?
ChavvyVicki.
Here we go. Ian, sorry to hear about all the unpleasant... I don't really want to talk about this in the week, but we can talk about this on a Sunday, because it's different rules. Sorry to hear about all of the unpleasantness over your well-deserved Presenter of the Year award, caused no doubt by bitter jealousy from an unnamed fellow presenter, brackets Valen. Carry on the good work. You will always be Presenter of the Year in our hearts, but not legally.
Yeah.
P.S. Please can I sell my Ian Lee Presenter of the Year drink mat on the eBay? Oh, yes.
You can make some money out of that.
You could do... I've not mentioned this much in the week, because I don't like talking about it, but what has happened is, Someone has cried foul play over me being presenter of the year.
Yeah.
I don't know who it is. Balance. I don't know. Well, I don't. I'm not sure. I'm not going to say that because I don't know if it is him.
Yeah.
They've cried foul play and they want a recount of all of the votes. So I probably still will be presenter of the year.
Another one. Did you hear that? And another one.
I'm talking stuff. we're going to find out Wednesday, you know, if I still am presenter of the year or not. So.
Oh really?
Yeah.
Are you waiting with bated breath?
No, I'm quite confident I'll get it back because really? I know.
Oh, and another one.
yes, as far as I'm concerned, I haven't cheated, so that's fine. Anyway, Vicky, anything else or should we move on?
No, I'll play that clip. I'll play some music for you later.
Lovely.
See ya.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
There we go. I like people just hanging up themselves.
It's good noise.
The whole presenter of the year thing is descended into bitterness and feuding, but we'll see what happens.
Six.
Line 6, thank you. Line 6, you're on the wireless.
La cucaracha, she's a big fan of Finley. La cucaracha... Something nice on LBC. La cucaracha, all the calls go straight away to air. La cucaracha, just make sure that you don't swear. Escucha Ian Lee en LBC 97.3.
Thank you very much.
Wow.
That was good, wasn't it? I ruined it by belching.
It's not
that
your fault.
That wasn't the she wasn't the one that phoned up and sang La Cucaracha and it meant suck my winky. It wasn't that one, was it?
I don't think so.
She was the nice lady. I think we didn't.
That
she,
was a separate.
I've got her
altogether.
She did. Sorry, I'm just getting used to all. She did. This is her, isn't it?
Cucaracha,
yes.
Cucaracha.
Can't walk any. That was good. Okay. So that was 6, wasn't it? We're just going to go from 1 to 10 to start off with. Then we'll go a little bit random on the veranda. Line 7, you're on the wireless.
I still want to ask Tommy's children.
Yes. Yes. I believe that's probably a reference to the Boyd, who we've stolen the idea from, and will admit it freely. So that's good. 0870-9090-973. We're taking all your calls straight to air. And for example, we're going to go to line 8. Line 8, you're on the wireless.
Hello, Danny.
Yes.
Ian, why don't you get MSN?
Why don't I get MSN?
Yeah, it's good.
Why is it good?
Because you could talk to your friends.
I've got a telephone.
Okay.
I thought there was... The chat board has gone on ianlee.co.uk. I thought there was a chat room on there.
Yeah, but no one ever goes on that.
Well, it's not there anymore. I had a look at it. I couldn't find it.
Oh, bummer.
Yeah, bummer. I've got really bad indigestion. I shouldn't have had that pizza. Who's that name in that paper? Oh, it's the Take That Boys. It's the,
of course.
Village people. So, what can I do for you?
Huh?
What can I do for you? Hello? He bottled it. The bottler.
He's a bottler.
He's the first bottler of the evening. Well done, you. Good work. Let's go to line 9. We can do these 10 straight away. Here we go. Oh, press the wrong button. Line 9, you're on the wireless.
Hello there. Tommy Boyle here.
Hello, Tommy Boyle.
Hi,
how are you?
Let's get off that.
Yes. This is Ian Lee. Who is this?
I'm Tommy Boyd. Ash is here.
Well, say hello to Ash for me.
Hi.
What do you want to say, Tommy Boyd?
I think you know what I'm saying.
Well, I think I do know, but can you just tell us?
There's not enough hot tubs in our churches.
There should be more, shouldn't there?
Tell you what, whoever's doing that, that's very good, isn't it? Because that's a well-treated voice, and they're obviously doing it live.
Hmm.
I think what they have to do is get those pieces of dialogue on hotkeys so that they can choose the dialogue play next, but if you've got it lined up in order, it's not going to work.
But could you respond? I mean, could you, for example, say hello to Agent Chris? Are you that good, Tommy Boyd?
Crap.
Yes, I thought so. Mm. What's happening with your afternoon show on Southern Counties? When's it going to kick off? Come on.
Mm-hmm. Mm. That was fantastic. That was so surreal. It was beautiful.
Yes. Anything else, Tommy, or should we move on to line 10?
08704-2020.
Well, no, that's very naughty. People are going to phone.
Stop hold.
People are going to phone up Mike Stickin if you give them that number.
Extraordinary piece of radio.
Yes.
Fine man, great broadcaster.
Thank you.
Certainly.
Bye-bye.
Don't do it like that.
But goodbye.
Very good.
See you later.
Nice one, mate.
Cheers, Tommy, bye.
Yeah.
Okay.
You got it wrong.
No, you're going now.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Not at all.
Good night, mate.
I see.
Bye-bye.
Certainly.
Okay.
As if.
Yes.
That worked quite well, didn't it?
We could have worked better, to be honest, if you'd had a few more phrases. But excellent, Excellent effort, excellent effort.
That's top hole.
The top hole indeed, sir. Good night, sir.
I'm fine, thanks.
No, you're losing it a bit.
I see.
Yes.
Would you mind if I kissed you on the lips?
I would be very honoured if you do that, but I really think I should move on to line 10 now.
Me too.
Okay, cheers then, bye-bye.
Same here.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Sure.
Bye-bye. There we go. You see, 08709090973. Line 10 is gone.
Wow.
I've got really bad indigestion. I'm trying not to belch. I'm going to wait till line 10 comes up before we take another call. That was good. That, of course, was Tommy Boyd, who invented this whole thing, which we are ripping off. This has not been bad. The first half now, it's not been bad. Line 10's not... No, you see, no, that's... I don't want to start again, because I did say...
Give it five more seconds. There we go.
Oh, line 10, there we go. Lovely. Line 10, you're on the wireless.
Oh, it's gone.
Bottler.
Bottler.
Bottler. Here we go. Line 10. Line 10, you're on the wireless. Hello?
Hi, hello, I'm coming to speak to Ian Lee.
You're on the radio speaking to him.
Hello? Oh, sorry. Ian, ages ago, I rang up and made Mr. T say donkey over and over again.
Oh, yeah!
And I kept on forgetting to ring, but have you... Can you do it yet?
I don't know if I've got my Mr. T clips. I think we got... Oh, hang on a minute. Which bit do I have to play? Oh, it's, hang on, is it this?
Don't give me no back.
Mine's on a computer, I've got to double click a mouse, and it's a little bit trickier, hang on.
Don't give me no back talk, sucker.
That's as good as I can do it on the computer.
Cool.
Anything else?
No.
Okay. Thank you very much for calling.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
People have been very friendly this evening. Well, let's explain what's happening. We'll take some more calls in a little bit. 08709090973. It's Triple M. We're taking a call straight to air. Chris is sitting in the studio with me.
Hello.
He's nowhere near the screen. We have Gary behind the glass, who's giving me numbers and times and things like that, and it's all going very smoothly. Not had to use that button there, which is the dump button, which is kind of good. You can phone up and do pretty much what you want to do. If you're going to play a piece of audio down the phone, it's trickier to do it on a mobile because you get the buzzing. Have a little practice beforehand. I think that would have benefited Yasser no end to have had a little bit of practice, because, let's be honest, it was cack. He completely muffed it up. But that's fair enough. We're straight through to 1 o'clock. And this, hopefully, fingers crossed, is going to be a regular thing. We're going to give it a couple of months and see if it runs its course, which it might do, or see, you know, if it works, which it might do. I heard the psychic show on Friday.
What do you think?
She ain't psychic. I don't think she's psychic. Mm. I don't think personally. They had a psychoanalyst in. Well, that's not psychic. That's mind science. That's not speaking to,
like a psychiatrist.
Pretty much the same thing. But, I shall be listening. I'm listening again this week. I need to have it all. 08709090973.
Being a landlord.
Taking a call straight to air. Thank you, I've got to say, I've deleted the email. Dez's wife, I think, he really loves you, but I've forgotten your name. He's been helping me with my computer game, and I said if he gave me the information, I'd big up his lady friend, and I forgot to do that. And thank you to Andrew for sending in photographs of your ex-girlfriends. More calls straight to air after this. Okay, I'm slightly confused. Apparently there is a chat board on ianlee.co.uk, which I just think would be a nice thing to hang out at if you want to. But I can't seem to... this is how bad I am. I can't seem to find it. Someone says it's at the top of the chat page, of the message board. And someone... Lino said it's at the bottom.
Go back up to the top.
Okay, let's have a little look. That's where we are. Search member list, user groups, calendar, register, profile. It's not the end of the world, but it might be, let me just have a... Someone says it's at the top. Lino says it's at the bottom. I trust Lino because he sends us pictures of nudie nuns. I can't find it. I really can't find it. I'll have a look in the week. Sorry, I should have checked this out before. But you can go and post messages on there. The entrance to the chat board is now at the bottom of the main forum page. Does that mean the... Hang on a minute. It doesn't mean down there, does it? No. How interesting. No. Just give me 30 seconds. We can have a little look. See, no, it's not there. Enter the message board, diaries page, Lee mails. That's
not it.
No, that's the shout box. No, I can't find it. If someone can send me specific instructions, or you can go and have a little look and find out yourself. Anyway, it's Triple M. It's 3 hours of taking your call straight to air. Chris, look at Tony Blair. Chris is in the studio with me. If we run out of calls, I'm going to interview Chris. You really are reading an old paper. There are no new papers around, are there? So I want to read this thing about McCartney.
What's happened?
Well, all I read when I was... I've got water. That's what I should be drinking. When I was in the garage getting some water and Tic Tacs, I looked at the front of the News of the World, one of those papers, I don't know, and it said that McCartney and that lady had had a massive row. So there you go. I just cannot find where this thing would be. General Board, contacts, who is online? Do I need to log in to go and find this thing? If someone could let me know, it'll be good just if people can hang out there, but maybe we'll do it next week. Okay. Let's dive in. Let's go to line five. Line five, you're on the wireless.
Oh, come on, Chris, and sing with me. Hey, little hen, when will you lay me an egg for my tea?
Hey, you got your own dedication from the hen man. The hen man is quite a legend around these parts. okay, look, we're getting lots of, Lazelle is her name, but Des has emailed me calling me a Wally. Lazelle, Des, when he's not playing computer games, loves you very, very much.
You did mess up his shout-out.
I did mess up the shout-out, that's why I don't do shout-out. It's right at the bottom. It just says click to join chat. Hang on a minute.
Can they send you the link?
No, mate, that would be, improper. It's at the bottom of what? The bottom of the message board, is it? Well, while we're doing that, let's go to line, five. Line five, you're on the wireless.
Oh, I'm after Ian.
Hello, you're on, you're speaking to Ian, you're on.
No.
Yes?
Right, hang on. Ian, it's Leon from the Guildford. You've been dearly missed. I know you tried the afternoon show, but me and the girlfriend, we kept missing you.
We're still doing the afternoon show,
but this is more fun, isn't it?
Well, do you know, it is more fun.
It is more fun.
We have literally done no preparation for this show at all.
This is how you need to do it. It's all natural.
Well, I've relaxed a bit, but I've been quite nervous all day, and I haven't been nervous about doing the wireless for quite a few months.
You know what I think's going to happen?
Yep.
All your old, proper listeners... They're going to be back on the phone before you know it.
Oh, well, in some ways that's good. That's terrifying.
I think so. But welcome back.
Bless you, that's very kind.
You've been dearly missed.
I think I found out how we get the message, the chat room on my message.
That's good.
I think you've got to log in. So, hang on a minute. Let's just see if I log in, will that bring up the chat thing? Hang on a minute. Chat.
Have you got it working?
There we go. Yes, it works. So if you go to ianlee.co.uk, go to the forum. You have to sign in, and then there are people there already.
I'll tell everyone who I speak to.
Bless you. Lots of love.
Can we keep this going now?
We will have a go.
All right then. Take care.
See you later. Bye bye.
Bye bye.
So there we go. That's it. If you go to ianlee.co.uk, go to the forum. You have to log in, which I think is quite easy to do, and then a chat icon appears at the top. And possibly at the bottom as well. It's definitely at the top. I'm not sure. So that's good. And you can just go and have a chitty chat there if you want to. Doesn't really relate to the show, but it's kind of a nice thing to hang out and maybe plot an attack. Let's go to line 10. Line 10, you're on the wireless.
Hello, Sir Ian and Aslam Chris.
Hello there.
Hello, how are you?
Very well. Chris, how are you?
Fine.
Chris, I've noticed you're doing nothing. I feel that I'm ruining your evening by getting you to sit here and read an old newspaper.
Well,
this is like old times hearing you guys at this time.
It's craziness.
It is weird. So yeah, congratulations on the new show.
Thank you very much.
And you know, on Friday with Barry coming back and everything.
Yes.
I think you did the right thing, Ian.
I think so. I do think I was put in an awkward position by his stupid son Dave, who I think is an idiot.
The fast talking David. Do you know Ian?
Yeah.
Last week in a Spanish lesson, the Spanish teacher was playing us the clip of Dave in the pinner, Barry's son, speaking quickly.
Hang on a second, say that again.
In our Spanish lesson, our Spanish teacher, who's also a fellow LBC fan, will we listen to you in his lesson sometime?
Oh, man. Oh, you've mentioned that before, haven't you, I think?
On the Faraday show.
Oh, yes, well done. That's very cool. But they played a clip of Dave.
Yeah, it's available on your website for download.
Is it, or... What, so, are you asking me if it is?
No, it is. He downloaded the clip.
Oh, okay. Oh, right, I see.
Of Dave, when he first called up saying, having a go at you about banning Barry.
Oh, fantastic.
And singing Judy Mullins' praises.
Yes.
And with everything, he put it on in the lesson for us to listen to.
But what's Dave got to do with a Spanish lesson?
Yeah.
Yeah, nothing. Absolutely nothing.
Wow, that's kind of cool. Well, if Dave calls, hopefully Dave won't call in again, but...
Is he still banned?
Well, he can come on, but he'll get a blooming good punch in the ribs, verbally, if he does come on.
No, I thought, he is very amusing, but I think that he did put you in a difficult situation, but you did the right thing.
Okay, yes, it was awkward. Very
absolutely
awkward. I've got to wish Alex in the Sid Cup good luck with the GCSE.
Good luck,
and,
Alex.
An arts GCSE, 10 hours? 10 hours of creating art?
That's why I didn't do art. I wouldn't be bothered to sit there for 10 hours and create art.
No, nor would I. And just very quickly, I've got to give a plug for TommyBoydForum.com.
Go for it. Ian, should I listen to Tommy Boyd? Is he good?
Tom, hang on, let me just make sure I get the right thing. TommyBoydForum.com, I think it is, or maybe it's .co.uk, and there are nice people there. Yeah, he's good. I've got to say, his new afternoon show is a slow burner, but it's getting better.
Oh, that should be right then.
There are websites where you can download The Human Zoo, which is what we're ripping off here.
This is The Human Zoo 2, in a
Well,
way.
No, not I don't want to say that, because I don't want to tread on his toes, but it's, you know, it was
Triple M. Triple M is what it is.
Yes, it is what it is, but, you know, he did it first and did it better, and you can hear that on the internet. It's well worth having a listen.
Yeah, and it was good to hear the Hey Little Hen Man a minute ago.
Hey, that was good, wasn't it?
He dedicated it to Agent Chris.
Yeah, I know. That's the first time we've had that.
That's brilliant.
And that was very good.
Agent Chris has been very quiet. Is he not allowed to talk on the radio or something?
No, I'm reading the newspaper.
He's reading an old newspaper.
Any good? What old news is in there?
Give us an old news from April, whatever it is.
The People... Let me find something. Okay. Let me see what we've got here. Okay, Steel Tycoon Lashkishmi Mittal is the richest Briton of all time, according to a new survey.
Oh, go on, and who's number three in the list?
Roman Abramovich.
Who's second? This isn't the list I thought it was. There's a list that Nick Ferris had on.
It's only got, like, two now.
Nick Ferris not on the list?
No, Nick Ferris is not on the list, although Nick Ferris is up, of course, for a Sony Award tomorrow.
Of course, and with his many books and many talents.
Have you read his book?
No, I haven't read his book, but I've heard him, when I'm getting ready in the morning, I can always hear him going on about, the book.
That's Nick Ferris.
Yeah, absolutely. Many plugs for the book.
Yes, many plugs, bless him.
All right, well, I'm sure, apparently we're going to call you from the Spanish lesson one day. So.
Oh, man, that'll be brilliant, definitely.
A couple of weeks' time, last Spanish lesson's on... Thursday 18th or something, so we'll definitely call you then.
Mate, I look forward to it.
All right, Ian.
Cheers.
See you later,
Bye-bye.
Ian. Have a good show.
Thank
Bye.
You. Isn't everybody being very, very nice?
Everyone's
to see
very you? Nice.
Hopefully it'll kick off at some point, but you never know. Let's try line 8. Line 8, you're on the wireless.
Your mum, Ian, your mum. This is me.
There we go, that's more like it. Now we're talking.
That's not very nice.
I don't know what it was, but it was certainly terrifying. I like these ones. Let's try line 1, you're on the wireless.
Hello, mate, all right?
Yeah, very well, mate.
Good, yeah. Can I just say thank you for bringing Barry back? God bless you, sir.
Well, I was put in an awkward position, and I felt I had to. I couldn't really say no, but, you know, hopefully he'll behave himself now.
God bless you, sir. I salute you with all my courage, sir.
I accept your courage. Courageous salute.
I'm going to send you some spam.
Oh.
I'm joking, mate.
Oh, okay. That's fine.
Don't sound scared.
No.
But thank you, mate.
Thank you. It's a pleasure.
You are a god.
Bless you.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Amen.
Amen.
Bye.
Ian, sorry to bug you, but if you could please tell us the name of your amazing theme music, it would be very much appreciated. It's from Pee-wee Herman's...
Big Top... Big Adventure?
No, it's not Big Adventure. It's Big Top, isn't it?
Big Top.
The Big Adventure is brilliant. The Big Top film is rubbish. And it's by Danny Elfman, I think. I don't really know. Let's try line 1. You're on the wireless.
That's not very nice.
That's not very nice. Is it? That's very, very naughty. This is exciting, isn't it?
He normally wouldn't get on in a week.
No, exactly. Thing is, it's Sunday night. Who's listening? There's about 50 people listening. The odds are most of them are going to phone in. Should we try this one? Line 2, you're on the wireless. Oh, this is good, this one. Thank you for that. Brilliant. Brilliant. Let's try this one. I pressed the wrong button. Line 1, you're on the wireless.
Have you ever felt like this? When strange things happen, I go in round the Swiss. Hello.
Hello.
I eat poo-poo.
Don't bottle it, come on.
I eat poo-poo.
You eat poo-poo, well done.
Yeah. Do you eat hamsters?
Yes, I do. I shove them up my bum as well.
Okay.
Okay, thanks for calling.
Wee-wee.
Bye-bye.
Poo-poo.
Yep. Hold on, that was awful.
I expected more of that, to be honest.
That was awful, wasn't it? Well, and you know what? Fair play. We're 3/4 of an hour into it. That's the first really rubbish.
Yeah.
A child just saying poo poo, wee wee, do you eat hamsters? That's the first one. That's not bad. It could have been, you know, 3 hours of that. Line 7, you're on the wireless. Can't quite make that out. Hello? Hello? Oh, Mission Impossible.
Shut up, Paul.
I've got a mouth to the sausage.
Hop a doodle do.
Faggot. Roses. Pass it on.
Hello, my friend.
Hello, my friend.
You sound different on the phone.
Yeah, possibly.
Do you want some more?
Yeah, why the hell not?
I know it's something kind of wobbly and thing. You are freaky.
Okay. Busy line, busy line.
Awesome. Oh, yes. Awesome. I've got one too.
It's in 1960-something. A crack team were, fell off an airplane or something, and now they're the A team.
Dick. A little blow never hurt anybody.
See, I didn't know it was so long. Oh, it goes on. Thank you for that. We're gonna have to say goodbye because I've got to go and do this, I'm afraid.
Here's your chance.
She's just leaning over me. Well, there we go. We've reset the call counter. We should have done that at the start. Well, that's a nice little... Heather Jingles has edited that well, hasn't he?
Very well.
To make a nice little thing. Triple M, I'll explain it after 11 what's going on. If you've just tuned in, you're going to have to kind of put up with this nonsense for another 15 minutes. Then I'll explain. We're taking calls straight to air. For example, line 6 is on the wireless.
Hello.
Hello, line 6.
Oh, hello, it's me. Hello, it's Sophie in the Morden.
Hello, Sophie.
Hello, and I'm one of your hot MySpace friends, I think you'll find.
Oh, well, hang on a minute. I have to now go to MySpace. How do you know that you're hot?
Because we were emailing each other on Friday.
And your friend said that you fancied me.
Rather embarrassing.
But you know, don't be embarrassed of just fancying a lanky man. Let's... Hang on, so you're, Sophie, let me get find you on My Friends. Hang on.
Yes.
I want to show, Chris, there's two, I've got 181 now.
You're doing better than Chris already.
Well, I've destroyed Chris when it comes to that. Hang on a second. Why don't they list, list them alphabetically?
Yes, it doesn't make any sense, the order they put them in.
No, let's just find out. Anyway, so, who was your weird friend who emailed in
That's my friend's husband, Simon, and he knows that I'm a bit of a fan, and... When I said that I'd had an email from you, he went a bit nuts and sent you that very embarrassing email.
This computer's taking a very long time for some reason. We may not be able to find you.
I was going to ask you as well. You've been watching Prison Break.
No, do you know, I haven't yet. I've got the first 13 on DVD, and I put them onto my PSP to watch this. I'm such a geek. To watch it on the flight over to America. But on the flight over to America, I was sat next to a lovely man who would not shut the flip up. 7 hours of this guy. And then, Ian, On December the 2nd, 1982, at precisely 7:34, I saw Engelbert Humperdinck live in concert. He was like that, but...
Oh, man, you just have to say, please be quiet with those sort of people.
Well, yeah, luckily, this is very weird. He disappeared for 2 hours on the plane.
To where with who?
Well, I don't know. He just said, I'm going for a walk now, Ian. And I didn't see him for 2 hours.
Was he Irish?
He was Irish, yes, hence the excellent Irish accent. And then on the way back, I was going to watch Prison Break, it turns out that I'd recorded the volume levels too quietly.
You've got to get into it, because it was just amazing.
Is it worth doing?
It's brilliant. I mean, if you like Lost and Invasion and that sort of thing, it's amazing.
Invasion is finally picking up. It drags it out for a bit, but I just watched this last week's on E4, or this week's on Channel 4, and it's kind of finally...
I'm hoping something's going to happen, because it's dragging a little bit.
I've got a feeling that nothing is going to happen, really, then it'll go to Series 2.
Can't be doing with it.
Yeah, I don't know if I can, you see. I've invested a lot of time into it.
And you're quite far ahead in Lost, aren't you?
I'm on episode 20 of Series 2. It's just mind-blowing.
The first two new ones this week.
Oh, here's Sophie, Chris, here's Sophie.
Oh, have you got me?
Yeah, that's Sophie. Do you remember?
Oh, very nice.
There we go.
Thank you, Chris.
Your head's on a jaunty angle there.
Yeah, and do you know what somebody said to me this week? Yeah. They asked me if I'm wearing one of those PVC nurse's outfits in the photo.
Wow.
I'm not.
Okay, well, I'm trying to... The computer's being very slow today. I'm just going to your page, because it's...
Okay.
It's very tiny.
Well, I'm wearing, like, a sort of greeny top.
Okay. There's nothing wrong with those outfits.
Well, you know, in your own time.
In your own time.
Whatever you do.
Although, saying that, some of the people that have posted that are now my friends, are in... There's a woman in, a PVC catsuit.
Oh, yeah, seriously. Some people have no shame.
But as a bloke, I like that.
I don't think you're complaining about it, are you?
No, not at all.
Have you got the... Are you at my page?
No, it's just really taking a long, long time to... I know, if I close down... Here we go. If I close down these, it might...
It's good to have you back on the night shift, by the way.
Do you know what? It's kind of good fun. We don't know what's going to happen and how long this is going to last. You know, hopefully this is a permanent thing, but we'll see how it goes.
You seem a lot calmer than you do during the week.
There we go. I'm looking at... you're 31.
Oh, I'm an old woman.
I'm 33 in a month.
Oh, I mean, yeah, well, it's just a number, eh?
Well, no, it's an age. I'm just signing in so we can look at all of your pictures. So this is a little bit sleazy, but, you know...
I know, that's what I said. I felt a bit dirty, you know...
That tea in the park... Is that you in the tea in the park picture?
Yeah.
See, that's nice.
Thank you.
That's you wearing a lovely short skirt in the picture titled The Lovely Mobiles. Who are those fellas sleazing around you?
They're a Canadian band that I work with. They're very nice boys.
That picture of you looks different...
Look a bit weird in that. I had drunk a lot of Guinness.
Oh, we go. That would explain it.
Yeah, the Guinness and the whiskey.
There we go. So you look that's a different person to in that picture, though, surely, isn't it? That's
No, they're all me.
And you're at a Bon Jovi concert.
Oh, yeah.
Come on.
Oh, come on, the Jovi.
Well, there we go, you see.
Now I've embarrassed myself.
Yes. Well, listen, on my page now, there's a picture of me with Gene Simmons, so, you know.
Oh, like a real photo of you, not like with you with a...
Oh, it's really me now. Yes, I've changed it, and it's me with Gene Simmons from Kiss.
Good.
It's a bit blurred, though.
It's a bit blurred. Chris, tell Sophie why that picture is a bit blurred.
Because I took it.
And?
Was he a bit drunk?
No, he just muffed it up.
Just came out blurred.
That's lame. I mean, a chance like that and he blew it.
I know, exactly. Yeah, the picture I took of Chris with Gene Simmons came out perfect and he's not Chris's hero.
Crystal clear.
Absolutely spot on.
That's just a cruel joke, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a bitter twist of fate. Anyway, Sophie, anything else?
Can I have a bit of Knocker Stack Ferrari while I'm here?
Oh, do you know what? I think you could be in luck, actually, because if I look... here we go.
Get up with
Knocker Stack Ferrari
at breakfast.
Does that work?
Thank you.
Lots of love.
Bye.
Bye-bye. We're talking about MySpace. If you want to... It's a weird thing. It's so addictive. Mine is myspace.com/TheRealIanLee. Chris is the real Agent Chris. I've got to close it down because I would then just... There's lots of messages for me there and I would just spend the next 2 hours reading it. Okay, let's take another call to air. Let's try this one. Line 5, you're on the wireless.
Oh, yeah, nice one, Fifi. Stand up now for me, darling.
What? I believe he was implying he was having some form of kinky sex with my ex-girlfriend. Wow. there'll be a lot of that. Line 7, you're on the wireless.
Hi, Ian. Can I just do something for you?
Yeah, please do.
I've got a jingle for you. May you just hold on for a couple of seconds?
It's
really good.
Okay.
Right, here we go.
Turn your radio off.
Yeah.
Monday.
I can't hear the words.
3:30. No, 3 till 6:30.
I heard 3 till 6:30.
Yeah, I heard that. It didn't look like a voice, did it? Yes, I think in the voice, though, he's having sex.
I thought that was fitting good.
It's good. I tell you one thing, my friend. We couldn't hear the words very well.
Oh.
May I suggest you make a different mix with the vocals right up there?
Yeah.
But thank you for the effort.
Okay.
Thanks a lot.
See ya.
Bye-bye. I'm trying not to cut people off as well, unless we have to. But I'm trying to just let them, you know, realise that the conversation has come to an end. This is, you know, nearly the first hour is up, and I think it's been all right.
Not bad, not bad.
Well, there you go. You see, we have the seal of approval. Let's go to line 9. Line 9, you're on the wireless.
Hello, Ian. Hello, Agent Chris.
Hello.
Hello, it's Fred Harris.
Hey, Fred, how you doing?
Hey, how you doing, sir?
Good, good, good.
Good. I thought I'd phone in to tell you about what I've been up to today.
Go on, Fred. What have you been... Oh, do that, and then I've got a question to ask you.
Oh, well, I've been to a car boot today and got some stuff.
What stuff did you get, Fred?
Oh, I got some magpie annuals.
Oh, lovely.
And I got a soda stream.
Yeah.
And parts for my chocomobile, because I can't get them in the shops now.
No, you can't get them in the shops, can you?
No, no, no.
May I ask you a question, Fred?
Yes?
Why did BBC, the BBC television company, make BBC computers?
Well, it's because, that we decided to, make computers so that we could do all the graphics for BBC.
There you go, you've answered. It genuinely puzzled me the other day.
Oh, that's a very puzzling question, sir. Anyway, I'll catch you two later.
Thank you.
Hurrah.
Bye-bye, Fred. Bye-bye.
Myself and my
help. To Clark from Tracy, apparently. Okay, we'll carry on this pace, and maybe after 11 we'll speed things up a little bit. 08709090973. Let's go to line 5. Line 5, you're on the wireless.
Hi, Ian. It's Ali from Dubai.
Hi there.
Hi. I'm telling of you because you made me cry.
Well, I'm very sorry about that, but you probably deserved it. Line 3, you're on the wireless.
Hello, Ian.
Hello.
Are you in touch with your feminine side?
Every other Thursday.
Good. Good, good. Thank you. Bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Okay. That's two in a row of them rubbish.
Yep.
Let's see if we can get rubbish right up to 11 o'clock. What else might be rubbish? Line 10, you're on the wireless.
Hello. I've lost my prune juice. I was wondering if you could help me find it.
No, probably not.
Okay, bye.
Bye-bye. Three in a row, rubbish.
Three in a row.
Three in a row. Absolute cack. Let's try line 6. You're on the wireless.
Right, 12:07 then. Let's start the show with a bit of Michael Gray. Get it the weekend started. Around the world from London. We broadcast.
Who's this?
Everywhere. We love you wherever you are. We really do not care. In Canada, Australia, in Scotland, or Pennsylvania. We love all of our listeners, yes, even those in France. We love you, forget lovers.
This is good.
For your show.
Chris Miles.
International Radio.
Big up, the Angus Bulbury, massive.
Big him up. That's not Chris Miles now, though. That's not his jingle now, is it? I don't listen to him. I find him obnoxious.
It sounds very outdated.
I've met him a couple of times. Well, that's his act, isn't it? I've met him a couple of times, and he was really nice and shy the first time. This was when he was just gone to Radio 1.
Mm.
And then he became a tit. Line 3, you're on the wireless.
Oh, this place is great. Ian,
thank you. Okay, we can do rubbish right up until 11. This is going to be fun. What's this? I don't know. Let's go there. Line 6, you're on the wireless.
Hi, Ian. Do you ever suffer from motion sickness?
Occasionally.
As do I, especially when I eat raccoons.
Lovely.
Yeah, another thing,
Well, that was a thing. That was a thing, was it? Okay.
Do you like waffles? Do you ever like waffles?
Yes.
Was that waffles?
I think it was waffles. There's a computer, which is the one that will let me look at the...
Oh, it's that white one.
Is it this one? I will have this, just in case, but, keen to know what was being said there. Oh, is that what it said? That was that one, was it? Okay. He's rubbish, but that's, let's go for one more before the, let's go there. Line 5, you're on the wireless!
I managed to steam his way to the top of the taxi. I need a 200. I need a 200
to beat him tonight. For you tomorrow. It's got to be said. So, we need to please do it tonight if we're going to do it. Crystal.
Hello, my friend.
Hello, my friend. What's that?
Your old recording.
Of what? Of me?
Yeah.
From when?
Dinner sometime, some years back, I don't know.
Dinner?
No, some years back, I don't know.
But what was it from? Is it from the radio or the TV?
No, radio.
What, on LBC?
Yeah, you're going on something out of Tex League.
Oh, the Tex, some years back. Well, I've only been here a year and 5 months.
Okay, then months back.
Okay, thank you.
Bye-bye.
Not a bad first hour. Chris?
Seven out of ten.
Okay, well, let's see if we can do better after the news. More of your calls straight to air after the latest LBC 97.3 news. I've been very naughty. Sorry to keep banging on about this MySpace thing, but it's kind of my new toy at the moment.
It's a bit addictive, isn't it?
It's very addictive. The real Ian Lee and the real Agent Chris are two you want to join. We're having a competition so you can get the most friends. I have a picture of Gary King up from the early 80s, and someone has posted a comment, Breathe has posted a comment, oh dear, oh dear, oh dear. Now, that's not nice. That's a little bit unfair, I think. You can email in, ian@lbc.co.uk. Ian, me and my boyfriend Nick have fallen out. If anyone can help, you can. Please tell him I love him, says Paula. Paula, dump him. He sounds like a loser. Sounds like a loser. You don't want to hang out with him. Go on MySpace. You'll find lots of hot people there. I guarantee it. I've got 202 friends! Come on!
That's because you're banging on about it all the time.
Well, I'm banging on about yours as well. Okay, Triple M, the first hour has been quite successful. We can do better, it's been quite successful. 0870-9090-973. We do the show 3 till 6.30 in the afternoon. Weekdays, and this is what we do 6 till 6.30. So we normally get half an hour of it. With the adverts, you're getting, what, about 12 minutes? Maybe a little bit more, 13 minutes. Mm. Of it. We've got 3 hours. There's hardly any adverts because no one listens to LBC at this time of night. They're all listening to Mike Dickens talking about how to evade your parking tickets. This is what he does on Sunday nights. There is nothing on speech radio on a Sunday night, so maybe, you know.
Although if you've got a parking ticket...
Well, then he's the fat man to... Well, buy Mike Dickens, what about... I would love someone to play a bit of Mike Dickens down the radio to us, if you get down the phone to us, if you can. We're the only alternative. I don't know what BBC London are doing. It'll be rubbish, because everything they do, apart from Danny Baker, is rubbish.
Someone could play a bit of BBC London to us.
Jono's doing the breakfast show there. So your call's coming straight to air. Chris is in the studio with me, as you can hear. He's not behind the glass. Gary's behind the glass, who's, maybe slightly bored. But not as bored as when you play the best of Clive Bull, which is just a recording, I'm guessing. Which is much boring. But it was very funny. Exactly. Could be the best of Ferris. I think it's got a book out. I don't know. It was very funny when Lynn was singing Rivers of Babylon on Best of Clive Bull. Genuinely hilarious. 0870-9090-973. Right, okay, let's rattle through some of these. Let's do a 1 to 10 again, shall we? Line 1, you're on the wireless.
Right, Ian, listen to me very carefully, okay?
Yep.
If you suffer from pain after shingles, please contact Heather Jingles. And also, if you like a nice cup of tea, please contact Ian Lee. And if you hear someone crying, here's James O'Brien. Okay?
Thank you. Two of those rhymed.
Sorry?
Cry and Brian doesn't rhyme.
Oh, yes, it does.
Is that a threat?
If you feel like it is a threat.
Sounds like a threat.
I feel like it's a threat.
You better be scared.
I will be at some point.
Well, you best be.
Well, I will be. At some point.
Okay.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
He's still listening. He was recording that. That beeping noise is then recording on their mobile phone.
Do you feel threatened?
I do feel threatened. I'm not scared yet, but I will be scared probably this coming Wednesday. I suspect. Okay, let's go line 2. Line 2, you're on the wireless. Hello? Oh, line 2 bottled it. Bottler. Line 3, you're on the wireless.
Ian Lee.
Yes.
You're going on about your MySpace.
Yes.
Yeah, what is your URL?
I've been giving it out. It's myspace.com/therealIanLee.
Fantastic.
And there's also the real agent Chris.
Thank
really?
You.
Yes.
That's good. I'll add you both.
Excuse me?
I'll add you both.
Nice one. Thanks for the ad.
That's right.
I didn't know that was MySpace slang. A lot of people have been saying thanks for the ad, and I thought they meant that I'd been advertising MySpace, but it means... don't laugh at me!
That's what I thought it meant. I thought that's what it meant at first as well.
Yes.
And then I realised that I was just being stupid.
Have you been in touch with any hot girls on there?
Yes.
Some of them are stunning, aren't they?
Some of them apparently are. I can't see them, but my friend tells me that they're brilliant.
Of course, yes, yes, of course. I remember who you are, so yes. Yes. Well, yes, no, they are. But do you get any... I've had a few weird messages.
Yes. Have you said no to them when they've asked to be your friend, though?
The only person I've said no to is someone pretending to be Barry in the Watford, because I know it's not him.
Because he's not computer literate.
He's not computer literate. although, funny enough, I did get a shaky email from him yesterday, which right. I think it's from him. Next time he calls in, I'll check, saying that he's on his granddaughter's computer or something.
But he's banned, isn't he?
No.
Oh, did you lift the ban?
On Friday. Well, what happened on Friday was his stupid son, Dave, called in
right.
and put me in a really awkward spot...
Right.
By saying, I've got Barry here, he wants to come on, you've got to put him on. So I kind of, he put me in a very awkward position.
I heard the clips on your website, and they really do sound the same.
Well, Barry and Dave?
Yeah.
We heard them speaking at the same time.
Really?
On Friday, I'm sure we did.
They can be in the same room at the same time.
Yeah, but yes they were. They were in the same room at the same time.
So they're not the same person?
I don't think so, no.
Okay.
I'd be very surprised.
No, I believe you, actually.
Okay.
That's good.
Anything else?
No, keep it up.
Thank you very much.
And you're really, really cool, and,
Hey, come on.
Well, there's loads of people think you're amazing.
Come on now,
I've turned about four people over to LBC in Leeds.
Oh, hang on a second, he's saying loads of people think I'm amazing. It's four people that he's got.
What do they have in Leeds? I only know six.
Oh, that
is quite good.
In terms of percentages, then, that's pretty good going.
It's not bad, is it?
No, that's fine. That'll do. We'll keep it. We've got the listening figures come out this Thursday.
They've never given me a diary, much to my disappointment.
Oh man, the thing is, one of those diaries is worth about 5,000 listeners.
I know.
So if anyone's, don't worry, I'm not so bothered about this show. This show can die on its arse and we don't get any listeners, don't care. But the weekday show, if you've got a Rajar diary, just fill it in for me.
Sympathy vote.
Sympathy.
The best thing is, tomorrow.
Yes.
I'm on its internet radio station.
Oh, yeah.
And I'm on between 2 and 3.
Lovely.
And then you start at 3.
Yeah.
So as I finish, I'm out with a little pocket radio, listening on my way home.
What? Hang on, what internet radio station are you on?
It's Smoke Radio.
Smokeradio.co.uk.
Yeah, University of Westminster Student Radio Station.
Are you sure this isn't some kind of druggy thing?
No.
We're not promoting marijuana or anything, are we?
No. Okay. It's Smoke as in London, as in the smoke.
The big smoke, the not big as day in day.
Genius.
No, not as in that. It's quite clever, isn't it?
It is very clever.
He's very quiet. Hello, Chris.
Hi.
Are you alright?
Yeah, how are you?
Yeah, no, I'm not too bad.
It's weird having Chris in the studio. I like it a lot.
It feels weird.
You don't like... Are you scared? Because you don't say very much.
No, I just haven't got much to say.
He's reading an old newspaper.
An old newspaper.
What's the date on that newspaper?
Well, like 1930s.
April the 23rd.
That's old.
Well, I haven't got much to do. I'm not screening the call, so...
Jen wants to be my friend. Jen's 17. I can't... That's slightly...
It's questionable.
Yes, it's... No, that's just bad news. Anything else?
No.
Thank you, sir.
Take it easy, big man.
Take care, fella. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
There we go. Well, people are being nice. I was hoping we'd get someone...
Very polite.
...phone in and have a Barney with me, but, maybe line five will. Line five, you're on the wireless.
Hello, Ian.
Hello. This is the crappiest beatbox I've ever heard in my life. And bottled it. That was rubbish.
Bottler.
Absolute bottler. Line six, you're on the wireless. Hello, line six? Bottled it.
Bottler.
Absolutely bottled it. Let's go to line seven. Line seven, you're on the wireless. Oh, no, what's going on here? Line seven, you're on the wireless. I do like this.
Wow.
I'm going to shut MySpace down because I keep looking at it. Okay, let's go to line, eight. Line eight, you're on, the wireless. Hello, line eight?
Hello.
Hello, line eight.
You're very tasty.
Yes, you should be in bed, shouldn't you? Yeah, good boy. Line nine, you're on the wireless.
Oh, hi, Freddie.
Hello?
Hello?
I can hardly hear you. Pick it up, you lazy sod.
Hello?
There we go.
Freddie.
Yes?
Yeah, I just want to say Chelsea, one-man team.
I can't really understand what you're saying.
Chelsea are a one-man team.
Okay.
And Arsenal rule, and they're going to win Europe.
Yeah, well, Arsenal are fifth in the league, aren't they?
Yeah, No, they're fourth. They beat Wigan 4-2 today.
Hey, fair play, though, didn't they? Arsenal had The Who playing for them, and The Who, they played a special song written by Roger Daltrey.
Yes.
So that's good. To get Roger Daltrey... To get Roger Daltrey to write a song for your football team, that means you've got to be good. He's bottled it. It's gone. And then line 10 is on the wireless.
Mayday, mayday. Hello, can you hear us? Can you hear us? Can you... over.
What's this?
We are sinking. We are sinking.
Hello?
Hello?
This is the German Coast Guard.
Can you hear me?
What are you thinking about?
What is this?
My health is not in question.
There we go. That's a quote from Mike Sticking. Mm-hmm. Let's quickly try line 7. Line 7, you're on the wireless.
Hi, Ian.
Hello, line 7.
It's Seth here.
Hello, yes, sir.
Yeah, I said I was going to do the music for you now, the one I tried to play earlier.
Okay.
But I can't because I'm going to get in trouble if I play it this time and the people are asleep and they're going to... I'm going to get in trouble, so I'll try to do it during the week sometime.
Just turn it down a little bit, then.
But I'm not sure if it's going to... If you're able to hear it, so I'll try it. I'm not sure if you'll be able to hear
it. Well, turn it right down and then just gradually increase the volume.
Oh, I don't know if this is going to work or not.
No, of course you don't.
No, I have no idea, okay?
No.
This is going to... Okay. Can you hear anything?
I can hear a really loud, irritating buzzing.
I don't understand why it's not working... It was working. Let me try to turn the TV off. See, that helps.
turn the TV off. Yes, that might help.
I don't know. I said this might not work. So
no, you did say that. You did warn us.
Yeah, I'm going to try one more time. If it doesn't work,
okay.
Tell me it doesn't work. Right?
Shouldn't you be in bed by now, Yasser?
Why? No, not really. I don't go to sleep until about 12:30, maybe 1:00. If I'm.
Oh man, that's crazy.
Because I can't get to sleep anyway.
No, that's mental. That is mental.
I wake up at 10 o'clock in the morning.
Oh, yeah, rocking!
That's not because I want to.
Oh, okay.
I can't get out of bed in the morning.
Liverpool. Right, yeah, so have another go, then I will go to some adverts.
All right, then.
What's that noise?
Is it working?
Yeah, so it's not. Do you want to give us a call? Try have another fiddle around with it and call us back in about half an hour.
How come Barry's back on then?
Well, if you were listening to Friday's show, you'd know why.
All right then.
Thanks.
Okay, then I'll try it, but bye then.
Speak to you in half an hour.
Good luck. I'll try again.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Don't forget, if you want to go to ianlee.co.uk, if you sign up on the message board, there's a chat room there that you can go and chat, if you want to, or you don't have to, taking your calls straight to air. Agent Chris is in the studio with me. Hello, sir.
Hi.
This is, very... Oh, look at you. You finished the paper now. Do you want to see if there's, like... Who am I seeing the Sunday Star? Today's Star? But the papers aren't around, are they?
Oh, I'll go and have a look.
Well, no, you don't have to. I'm not sending you off on a mission. But we've looked and they're not around, are they?
Hang on, let me see if I'm... I'll just go next door.
Have a look. No, they used to be able to get Sunday. Thing is, Mr. Hooker's so tight now. Chris is off, okay.
See you later.
I'll take some calls while you go. Line 2, you're on the wireless.
I put a nickel in the telephone, dial Yasser's number, got a busy line.
Busy line.
I wish I hadn't sung over that, it's very funny, thank you. Line 3, you're on the wireless.
Hey, Ian. Busy line. It's Josh, who you talking about MySpace?
Yes, Josh, I am.
Well, my band are on MySpace, we're getting quite big, we've got quite a lot of, friends, got 500, lots
wow.
of people.
That's a lot of friends. No papers, Chris?
Nope.
Josh, pardon? Josh is in a band that
yeah.
are quite big.
Oh, wow.
Pretty good band.
What genre?
It's general rock. Can I give you the website? It's like myspace.com/theprototypesmusic1.
The prototypes music one?
Yeah, but one is a digit.
Number one.
A number.
Prototypes music one.
That's the name of the band.
A very, very good band. It's called The Prototypes, but there's like one other band, so yeah.
There's another band called The Prototypes.
Yeah.
So you've become The Prototypes Music One, but that's not the name of the band.
We're called The Prototypes, but we have.
Well, that's the same. My band is called Boomhauer X, because there's another band called Boomhauer, and we put the X on the end like Liberty X. But that was like being postmodern.
I saw Liberty X.
Well, they
were at my friend's bar mitzvah.
I've had a. Wow.
Yeah.
I've had a row with the short, fat one from Liberty X.
Short, fat one?
Yeah, the one fat is... one. One, Michelle, is it?
I have no idea.
No, I have no idea.
Not
but
a
she's,
great fan.
She's a silly cow.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But I'm going it. It's a very good website.
I won't, but I'm sure people listening will do.
Yeah, prototypes, music-wise.
What? But, what? The original prototypes, what are they like? Are they any good?
Oh, we're better. We're much better.
Okay, you have to think about it.
Yeah, but they're like some American band.
Oh, okay.
They're not that great.
Someone sent me a link for the trailer for Lost episode 21, but I shan't follow that through.
We're like Lost, good.
Are you watching it on Channel 4, or are you watching
it? Well, my friend downloads all of them.
Okay,
so.
Well, that's illegal.
Yeah.
But well, so we don't condone that, but I have a cousin called Don Load who sends them to me from America.
Oh, yeah, Don Load. I've heard of him.
Mm. He's very good. So you're up to episode 20?
Yeah, I'm on the ones on Channel 4, but it's good.
Oh, it's very good.
Cool.
Kerry has emailed in. Hang on a second, listen to this, you might like this, as you're in a band. Ian, you just mentioned the Arsenal today, and Roger Daltrey, I did, because Roger Daltrey wrote a song for the Arsenal. As we know, Roger Daltrey wrote all of The Who's big hits. Did you see the band playing alongside him? Now, Chris, you saw this. Did you see a brass band playing alongside Roger Daltrey?
They were kind of in front.
Okay, that was Kerry's band.
No.
The Romford Drum and Trumpet Corps. Please leave a message on our guest book, our kids would love it. We also recorded that song Highbury Highs on Tuesday, and Roger Daltrey... Oh, they recorded the Roger Daltrey song.
Wow.
Ooh.
Can anyone play it to us?
If anyone can play Highbury Highs... Oh, it's for kids with cancer. I shouldn't have dissed it. Sorry. I'm not dissing cancer, I'm just saying, you know. Well, I will try and sign the guest book later, Carrie, if I get the chance. Josh, anything else?
Not really. That
okay.
Was it.
Bless you. Thank you very much for calling.
Okay, bye.
Bye-bye. Chris, pick a number.
Seven.
Seven. Oh, seven's, gonna be interesting. Hello, seven.
Hello.
Hello there.
Could you go on my website?
Probably not. I think we should, you know, kind of, if you want to promote your website, then you can, but I'm not gonna get the chance to look at any more websites.
Okay, it isn't bad.
Who is this?
It's Jack.
Hello, Jack.
It's StuffNetZero.
Yes.
Dot tripod.
Oh, that's a new one.
Dot com.
Okay.
But no www.blog.
No www. Okay.
And can you read out my email?
What is your email?
I sent you one.
I'm not. The thing is, I'm not reading out all the emails really. I'm just picking the ones that are good.
Okay.
You said Ian, can you the mini fridge?
Yeah.
I read that one out.
Okay.
So I did.
I didn't hear it.
Okay.
Okay.
Thanks a lot. Bye. Next time, Chris, pick a better line. That was rubbish.
All right.
So just a kid, boring kid.
Well, I didn't know. Two.
If you want to come on and plug your website, you can, but it's quite dull, so don't. And I won't go and look at them, unless it's hot chicks, and then, man, I'm there.
Pick number two.
You want number two, okay. Line two, you're on the wireless. Hello? Line two?
Goodbye. Goodbye. Thanks for that. Line three, good evening, welcome.
It's a very quiet Tommy Boyd.
Human two.
Can you turn it up a bit?
One, good evening.
It's a bit too quiet.
Hello?
It's a little bit too quiet.
Can you hear that?
It's very quiet. Can we have it a bit louder?
All right, 1 minute.
Go on, really loud.
All right, cool, 1 minute.
Okay, well, you say 1 minute.
It's a long time, isn't
it? A long time in this kind of stuff.
Do you reckon?
No, I don't reckon. I know. This is crap radio. This is the crappiest radio I've ever been involved in. This is unbelievable rubbish.
That's genius.
I don't know what's going on with these phones.
Well, yes, you do know what's going on with these phones.
What?
You know perfectly well. Don't say you don't know what's going on with the phones. Be honest. You know exactly what's going on with the phones.
Well,
people being diverted away. There are a bunch of messages.
Well,
and then people who are trying to make decent contributions to a phone-in program simply can't. And I'm taking phone calls on phones that are lit up all across the radio station with people saying that they've been spending 20 minutes trying to get through the air and they can't. That's what's going on, isn't it?
Well, yeah, but tonight particularly is
that's
things
ash.
Worse.
Mm.
Well, that's what's going on, isn't it?
Well, it's definitely...
Well, that's what's going on, isn't it? I don't piss about, that's what's going on, isn't it?
Well, I think, no, because there have been technical problems all day, so I don't know whether it is.
Oh, come on, get real. Be straight, Ash. Go on, you're the guy who always plays the hippie and always pretends he's straight. Be straight, that's what's going on, isn't it?
Well, yeah, I mean...
All right, my friend, thank you for that.
Hello?
Thanks for that.
That's all right.
Cheers.
All right, bye-bye.
Bye-bye. That's just a bit muffled, you can hear. Good. That's good, that's the human
We could all take a page out of Tommy Boyd's book.
Yeah, we could do.
Or a whole show.
we could just rip off a whole show of his. And just say, are you cold? You're cold.
I'm freezing now.
Let me turn the heating up a little bit, but then I get...
Okay. Well, start to faint. I'll take it in turns.
Okay, we'll alternate. That's got to be good for our constitution. Line 6, you're on the wireless.
Hey, pick up the phone. Hey, pick up the phone.
Okay, thank you. That was rubbish. I'm going to do one more of those, and we'll try some others. Let's go to line 4. Line 4, you're on the wireless.
Hello, Ian.
Hello, line 4.
Hi, it's Dave, mate.
Hello, Dave.
It would be all right if I told a joke.
Yeah, go on.
All right, there's three men.
It's not racist in any way, is it?
No, not at all.
Okay.
There's three men, one Irishman, one Englishman, and one Scottishman.
Right, that's going to be slightly racist then, isn't it?
No, it's not racist, Wait, well, let me start again.
Is it racist against the Irish?
No, it's not racist, mate.
Well, but the very fact that there are three men of different... Why can't they all be of the same nationality?
Right, there's three men, and they go in the pub. And one man says to the other man... No, wait. There's three men, and they go into the pub, and then they say to the other man... I've forgotten it completely.
Keep going, you're a good lad.
Alright, there's three men.
Yeah?
I'm just gonna check it now.
There's three men.
Who are you checking it with?
What?
Well, have you got it written down? Is that why you're checking
it? Yeah, I wrote it down on my hand.
Okay. So three men.
And they go into the pub, right?
Yeah.
And then they say to the barman, can I have a pint? And he says, no, mate, there's three of you.
Why are you laughing?
Oh.
I don't think it's funny. Well, thank you for that.
All right, cheers, mate.
Please call in again with another joke.
All right, cheers.
Thank you. Once we de-racialisticalised it,
yeah.
It became...
He couldn't really tell it, could he?
No, he lost its power. Maybe you have to be racist to be funny.
Maybe.
I don't know. I'll ask Nick Ferris in the morning. Line 1, you're on the wireless.
G'dang, g'dang, Ian.
Hello?
G'dang, g'dang, mate.
G'dang, g'dang, my friend.
Well, hey to Agent Chris.
Well, hey.
Listen, thank God you guys are on a Sunday. Something decent on the radio. I've got this mental image all across London. Yeah. You know the old Ovaltine adverts? They're all the kids and the mother and father crowded around the radio, something to listen to.
Yes.
That's what I'm imagining is happening right now, mate.
This is going to hurt, so hopefully this is going to be a sucker punch to talk sports and Mike Stickin.
Well, I think it will be, won't it? There's no contest, is there, mate?
No contest, mate.
No contest at all.
Lovely.
What was Ovaltine?
What was Ovaltine?
Yeah. Was that hot chocolate? Was that coffee?
No, it was like a malted drink.
It was like cocoa, wasn't it?
But no, it wasn't chocolate, though. It was malted.
Malted, yeah.
But no, it's not chocolate. It's malt.
Malted what?
Just like it's malt. It's a malt drink. Taste of malt. Malt is a flavour.
I've never tried malt.
It's not a very nice flavour. It's like Horlicks.
Horlicks.
It's like Horlicks.
But that's coffee. I thought Horlicks was coffee.
No, Horlicks isn't coffee. No. Horlicks is malt.
Malt.
I tell you what, next Sunday I'll bring in some malt.
Malt.
And you can try a malt drink.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
You'd enjoy that.
Yeah, you'd love it, wouldn't you?
Yeah, cushy stuff, mate. Cushy.
Cushy, little pup.
Cushy.
Anything else?
No, that's it, Ian. Thanks very much, mate. I'm going to listen to you all night.
Nice one. How has it been sounding so far? Because we're enjoying it, but is it a little bit self-indulgent?
No, it's nice. It sounds brilliant. At least, I think, for once, we can hear Chris laughing. I know he's laughing in the background normally, but we can actually hear him enjoying himself today.
I don't know if he's enjoying himself. Chris, are you enjoying yourself?
Yeah, it's not bad.
There we go, you see. All right, listen, thanks for that.
Cheers, mate.
Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. Now, we've got a minute to go to the break.
So four.
Oh, you reckon? Okay, let's try live 4. Live 4, you're on the wireless.
Hello?
Hello?
Hello. I just want to know one thing. Why were you so bad on TV?
Why was I so bad on TV?
Yeah, why?
Because I didn't have a clue what I was doing.
Yeah. Why? Well, this show is really good, but you were just terrible on TV.
It's awful, isn't it? That's why I don't work on TV anymore.
I know, but you were just so bad.
Yeah, I know.
I couldn't believe how
awful.
Bad you were.
Awful, and they paid me thousands of pounds to be awful. It's incredible, isn't it?
It's bad.
Well, luckily, I've not been on TV for a while, so you haven't got to watch it anymore. You can watch Dermot O'Leary instead.
He's terrible.
Okay.
He's worse than you were on TV.
He's a very nice man, though.
Who do you like on TV?
Sorry?
Who do you like on TV?
anyone with big tits.
There we go. Okay. We have to go to a break now.
Okay.
Thank you for saying tits.
Thank you.
Bye bye.
Join Sky TV now, and you can get.
Oh, it's finished. 08709090973 is the phone number. It's 3 hours of taking your calls directly to air. No screening, no messing around, it all goes straight to air. So if you call, and you hear me speaking on the phone, that means you're on the air. 08709090973 is the phone number. Another hour and a half of this after the news. Sarah Marie Love. Fox FM, I don't know. Chris is now behind the glass, just doing the stuff while Gary nips off and makes us a lovely cup of coffee, which Hi. Is very kind of him. Hello. Oh, you can still speak, can you?
Yeah.
Oh, nice. So there you go, see? Who's this? Holly Hotlips is a bitch. Miss Spiritual Tramp of 1948. Nice. It's just lots of... I like that picture. It's just lots of hot girls, it would appear, on MySpace. Are they genuine, or are they... made up. Who knows? Who cares? 08709090973 is the phone number. Your calls are going straight through to air. Let's steam through and do some of these, shall we? Let's go to line 8. Line 8, you're on the wireless.
Hiya.
Hello?
Is that you, Ian?
Yes, it is.
Is that Ian of the Lee?
It certainly is.
I'd like to make an assumption.
Please make an assumption.
I think Barry's your mate and Catherine Tate is his wife.
There you go, you see. There's an assumption.
I've got a poem for you.
Lovely.
Can I give you a poem?
Where's your accent from?
It's from the US of A.
Oh, America! I've heard of this place.
Right. Hey, listen, I'll tell you something. You know we're all confused? Yeah?
Yes.
We're all a little confused these days.
Yes.
I'm a wolf in sheep's clothing. I'm a man in drag. I'm an addict. God damn it, give us a fag!
Wow, there we go. This is what Sunday night should be like. Line 10, you're on the wireless.
About the job. Oh, no, it's
a woman. Mike's dicking!
No, she can't. Not if it's going to influence the way in which that child is brought up. And anybody that thinks and really believes that a 60-odd-year-old parent who's to be soon 70...
He's talking
the child,
about that old woman who's having a baby! That's what's happening on Talk Sports now!
The sort of parenting...
That's 3 days old, isn't it?
Oh, unbelievable. Thing is, Charlie Wolf will do this. Well, thank you, we should probably leave it there. We're probably breaking some copyright law of playing another station's output, but thank you for that. That's what's happening on Talk Sport. Charlie Wolf will be doing that as well, straight after. Hmm. That's 8 solid hours of talking about that 63-year-old woman having a baby.
Wow.
Wow, indeed. Line 3, you're on the wireless.
All of which makes me anxious. At times, unbearably so.
Is it just me? Is there a pause in that that's getting longer? Or am I just imagining it?
I think it's all in your head.
Maybe it is, I don't know. I'm glad he called him. Let's try line 10. Line 10, you're on the wireless.
Am I just imagining it?
Hello?
Hello, line 10.
Ian, it's Paul Ladbroke Grove here.
Oh, Paul, don't you sound a little bit slower at night time?
I have slowed down a bit. I had a couple of Guinnesses earlier.
God bless you. Normally you're all, hey, oh, hey. And now you're like, hello, Ian, it's Paul here in the Ladbroke Grove. How you doing, man? You all right?
I'm all right, sir. Do you remember I said I'll play you some Zappa?
Oh, yes, please.
Okie dokie. Now, do you know the one Joe's Garage?
Yes, I do. I know, yes, I do. I couldn't sing along with it, though.
This isn't it.
Okay.
Leave your money, don't go to the show. Well, I turned around the night, said, oh, oh. Well, I turned around the night, said, oh, oh. Well, I turned around and I said, oh, oh. And the northern light commenced to glow. And she said, oh, oh, with a cheery laugh.
Well, Zappa is an acquired taste, but he is a genius.
You like that little bit there, Ian?
I remember that. That's on an album that's got a yellow cover, isn't it?
It's called Apostrophe.
Apostrophe. It's not one of his best, but that's a good song. Don't Eat Yellow Snow.
It's not bad. It's not bad.
Well, God bless you.
I've got some other stuff to play you later on that I think you'll like.
Bless you.
Sir, welcome to Sunday Nights to you and Agent Chris.
Bring it on!
Come on!
Lots of love!
You too, cheers!
Bye-bye!
Bye-bye!
This is fun. Let's go to line four. Line four, you're on the wireless.
Hello, Ian, how are you?
Hello, sir, what kind of you?
Not much. Well, I thought you might want to... Yes, I didn't make it with the Indian music, so I thought I might take his place.
Go on, then.
Hold on a second. Hold on. Sorry, hold on.
Doesn't everyone sound tired?
Mm. Everyone sounds a lot slower in the evening, don't they? It's a classic. Mujhe chore ke, mujhe chore ke. Har desi jana nahi.
I just thought, you know, yes, I didn't quite make it. He had several attempts.
We love a bit of Pardesi.
I'm glad you do. I will be dropping that stuff in. I'm going to wrap it up. I should have done it this weekend, ready for you on Sunday, but I'll wrap it up and I shall drop it in at some point.
That's very kind of you.
No problem, darling.
Lots of love.
Welcome to Sunday night.
Thank
bye.
You. Bye-bye. Everyone's being too nice. I was hoping someone would call in and kick off. You can't obviously manufacture that stuff. That happens if and when. But everyone's being lovely. Let's have a quick look to see what these emails are saying. Ian at lbc.co.uk. Ian got back from my holidays this morning. Glad to hear Barry's back, says Sarah. Let's quickly just go through some of these. Ian, long time no Lee. Great to hear you once again tonight. I'm on in the week. Maybe people don't know that.
Maybe they think you've been sacked.
Maybe they do. Sorry you broke up with Fifi. You've got an opportunity to screw game show hostess Caroline. Well, no. That's not very nice. But Caroline is fit. There's no denying it, but, just say hi, what a brilliant show. Any chance of having Barry in the studio as a guest one Sunday?
Here's your coffee.
If possible. Hey, Gary!
Hey, yeah. I like the Zapper.
Zapper was good, wasn't it? Charlie Wolf spoke about that alderman last night. I heard him telling Mike Stickin he was going to talk about it, and Dickin said, I'm going to talk about that tomorrow. There we go. Okay. Line 6, you're on the wireless.
Hey little hen, hey little hen, when, will you lay an egg?
Okay, keep going.
Will you lay an egg for my tea?
Keep going.
For my tea.
And again.
Hey little hen, hey little hen.
Hey little hen, hey little hen. When, will you lay an egg? Will you lay an egg? For my tea, for my tea.
Moo, 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 moo. Moo, 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 moo.
Moo, 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 moo. Moo, 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 moo. Moo, 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 moo. Moo, moo, moo. Moo, 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 moo. Moo, 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 moo. Moo, 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 moo. Moo, moo, moo. Moo, 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 moo. Moo, 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 moo. Moo, 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 moo. Moo, moo. You're one behind, I think. I think you were out of...
I wasn't. I was there.
Thanks for that. That was fun.
That was good.
When I used to do rounds at school, I used to get really tense because it's
so much pressure.
There's a lot of pressure. If you muff, especially if there's like five of you and you're the third round,
yeah.
If you muffed up, you've ruined it for everyone.
Yeah.
So much pressure doing rounds. Line 8, you're on the wireless.
Hello.
Hello, line 8.
Hi, it's Laura. Hang on a minute. I'm going to turn down the radio.
Everyone's voices is completely knackered at this at 20 to 12 at night.
I'm hitting the brandy.
Come on now, don't do this to yourself.
Well, it's one way to get to sleep anyway. Listen, I was listening to your Domino's pizza guy and he has this really cool South African accent. And I've lost the plot now because I had something really clever to say. But can you have more South Africans ringing up? Male South Africans.
It's a good accent, isn't it?
It's lovely. I'd kill for it.
Jesus.
Is that a threat?
Are you threatening us? Is that a threat?
That is a threat.
Wow, it's a sexy threat.
Oh, yeah, and can you do your lecker and roar for me?
Yeah, that's lecker, you know, it's raw. That Vandermurfer, he's raw, you know.
Who is Vandermurfer?
Vandermurfer is like Paddy Murphy. And so you'd say, how do you confuse Vandermurfer? You know, you put him in a round room. I can't do it. In a round room and tell him to stay in the corner.
Oh, dear.
There you go.
Okay, but you know Dutch guys are the best-looking guys in the world.
Are they?
Yes, that's what they had a poll.
The Dutch guys had, right, the Dutch guys had a poll?
I am drunk, I'm sorry. I think I'd better get off and stop embarrassing myself.
I think I've fallen in love with Holly Hotlips.
Oh, who's she?
She's, look at that picture of her, boss, look at that picture there. She looks stunning there, doesn't she? Bottom left wow. corner of her pictures. I like that kind of dark bob. No, that's not her, though. The real one.
What's she called, Polly Hotlips?
I don't know. Well, I guess she's a good kisser, is she?
Oh, I don't know. What is your favourite kiss? How do you like it? Deep and penetrating or soft and gentle?
I like a mixture of both. I like a, you know, like a really passionate, full-on, just eating each other's faces and a gentle...
Oh, no, I like it gentle. Then you can sort of slowly build up to the deeper.
There we go. Well, we can never kiss, nor can we. Thank Christ for that. Wow. Got out of that one.
Okay, I'll let you go.
Thank you, Nora.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Lots of love. Wow, thank God for that. I got out of that, so that's good. Okay, where...
Line 7.
Line 7. You want 7? Okay. Line 7, you're on the wireless.
Hi, Ian. It's Caroline from Wandsworth.
Hi, Caroline. How you
took doing? Me about half an hour to get through.
Yeah, it was a bit... Well, we thought it would kind of die out by about 11, but all of the lines are really busy, so...
Yeah, they're well busy. I just want to say it's really nice to have you back in the evening, because I haven't heard you... on your day programme. Last time I heard you, you was doing weekends.
Why don't you listen to the day programme?
Because I'm doing this course thing at the moment, so by the time I get home, it's about 5.
Right, well, it's still an hour and a half.
I know,
don't tell me you watch Deal or No Deal.
No, I don't. I like that. I have watched it, but by the time I get home, cook myself out 3, it's about 6:30, 7:15.
But you can listen to the radio while you're cooking,
yeah,
that's what I do.
Yeah, I will do in future. Yeah, I will do.
Why had you not thought of that?
No, not really, because I do like watching Neighbours.
Oh, you silly man.
I know. Are you glad, I'm not sure which football team you support, but are you glad Chelsea won the Premiership?
I don't support any, but I pretend I support Chelsea, and yes, I'm very glad. Hey, what's all this going on with Tottenham Hotspurs?
What do you mean? I haven't heard anything.
Well, allegedly, they've all suffered food poisoning before a very crucial match.
When? Today?
Yeah, well, last night there was, and the police are involved, so we probably can't say too much about it, but,
Were they staying in a hotel or something?
Staying in a hotel, and they've 7 of them were out with food poisoning.
I reckon it's one of the Chelsea supporters got in there, you know, a waiter or something.
Probably we don't know say that. Well, it's not gone to court, so we can say that, I think. When it goes to
and
court,
I want
to
be Agent Chris's friend.
You want to be whose friend?
Chris. Is it Agent Chris?
Agent Chris, yes?
Yeah, his friend. Because you said you're having a competition between you and him. Who's got many friends?
But yes, on MySpace, not in real life, but on the computer.
Yeah, I realise.
Not computer. In real life.
So no. But I'd be his friend in real life as well.
You wouldn't want to.
Why not?
It's myspace.com/therealasiancrisp.
I haven't got a computer, so... But mind you, I can get hold of one, because my niece has got one.
A hooky one?
No, he's got a laptop for Christmas, so...
Has he?
She's got the internet as well.
Oh, I've heard of this, yes.
Yeah, so...
What fags do you smoke?
I'm smoking now, actually.
I can hear it.
Mayfair.
Oh, Mayfair, that's...
Long one. Do you smoke?
No, not at all. Very bad for you. Gives you cancer.
How's Fifi, okay?
We split up.
No.
This is what happens when you miss...
No, I don't believe you.
No, I wouldn't joke about an 8-year relationship.
Seriously?
Yes, yeah.
But you're still friends?
No, I've not spoken to her for months.
Oh, gosh, I'm really sad to hear you now.
Well, there you go.
I was thinking you haven't mentioned her for a while. I'm really sorry to bring it back up for you.
That's okay. It's just a lot of painful memories.
Okay.
Hey, listen, I've got...
good memories as well, hopefully.
Somewhere. I've got to go.
Okay, good night.
Lots of love.
Chris, Ian.
Wow. How weird is that? Bog off and pass... taking a call straight to air, for example. Line 4, you're on the wireless.
Oh, hello. It's Peter Dealy here.
Hello, Peter.
I'd just like to say hello to you, Ian Lee, and Christian Mitchell. But I'd like to say I do not like it when people come on the air and pretend to be me. Can you stop that, please?
We will have a go, Peter.
Oh, good. Now, can you give them a big slap on their bop-bops? Well, I'll be going now, Ian.
Thank you.
Good luck. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
It's nice of Peter to call in.
It's very nice of Peter to call in. Who is it tonight? It's Adrian Allen, isn't it?
Yes.
Who I've not met, although I've stood next to him in the office and didn't realise it was him until I left... and I heard him speaking, and I recognised his voice.
Mm.
So that's going to be a little bit awkward. I'm assuming he's going to pop in and do a song for us. Is he going to do a song for us?
Hopefully.
We've booked Adrian Allen to do a song for us. But so it's going to be a little bit awkward, because I've stood next to him and never said hello to him. But he's good, I like him. Again, you're faced with a choice. Do you have Charlie Wolfe, or do you have Adrian Allen? There's no choice. You go for the Allen every time, surely. Nuke Iraq! Nuke him! Let's invade Iran! Iran! Line 3, you're on the wireless.
Hello, this is Rocco.
Hello, Rocco.
Rocco Siffredi.
What?
Rocco Cifredi from the Hamworth.
Excellent stuff. Good to have you on board.
I've got a message for the hussy.
Okay.
Who's laying in bed with Paps Jr.
Lovely.
And I'd just like to wish her well with her text messaging tonight.
What is... Now, can you give it... This sounds intriguing. Is this to do with something rude?
A little bit, yeah.
Alrighty, good work. Okay, fine.
I'm based on a porno star called Rocco Cifredi.
You're in a porno star?
I wish I was, but she calls me Rocco.
Oh, I see. Okay, right, okay.
Because of our nighttime action, and right. That's my nickname.
Okay.
She's laying in bed with Paps Jr., which is the nickname for my son.
Right. Oh. Hang on.
I think I've gone into a bit too much detail, what do you reckon?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll leave it there then.
Thanks.
Have a good evening.
Bye-bye.
Cheers.
Bye. What just happened?
Something very, very wrong. Line 9, you're on the wireless!
Come in.
Hey! Igor Igor!
How are you?
How's it going?
Yeah, not bad.
You can make me whole again.
Oh, no.
It's good.
They put the microphone down, so it sounds like I'm singing melodies, you know.
Is it in here, this thing?
Yeah.
Which one's it on? Oh, there it is. Okay, we'll play it in there. Yeah, so that was good. That was you on Southern Counties. Tommy Boyd again, a recurring singer.
Sorry, I missed what you just said to Agent Chris.
Well, no, just your song is here that you sent in.
Oh.
I've not heard it.
Oh, yeah. It's this guy. Listen, do you want to hear him?
Who?
Brilliant guy, it's a comedian.
Andy Kaufman. Hey, listen, man, you don't have to tell me about Kaufman. I've got hooky DVDs of the man on Saturday Night Live at home. He's my favourite comedian.
Yeah.
Go on.
Turn that live and now is
Hang on, let's get beginning.
Thank you very much.
Here we go.
Kaufman's the man.
Mr. Trouble never hangs around. When he hears this mighty sound,
here I come to save the day.
That means that mighty mouse is on the way. Yes, sir, when there is a wrong to right, mighty mouse.
That's enough.
Well, yes, because that act only works if you see it.
Really? What?
Oh, can you put BBC Two on, Chris? I think there's something rude on there. Just had an email saying.
BBC Two?
Yeah, I think Rudy's on.
Mm. Oh, the piano's in the way.
Ian, I thought you were mediocre to great on TV. Okay. London is, we got a new MP3 from Funky Chunky Cold Medina.
Yeah?
Now listen, I've got to say, anyone listening, if you send in an MP3 during the show, I can't play it because it has to go onto a different computer. If you send in one before the show, with a bit of work, we can get it onto the right computer. But if you send it in during the show, I can't play it, I'm afraid, because it's on the wrong computer. So, hang on, shall I play your song, Igor?
Okay.
Is it any good? I've not heard it.
Yeah, okay.
Okay. This is Igor's song. I've not heard this at all.
But I decided I had to. I was always playing live, but don't get recognized till after. So I fake my own death just to see what would happen as I take shallow breaths and wait for people's reaction. It was funny at first, but I had to hold my laughter away. For long I was on display in an open casket way. And I'm the main attraction, goes to play on freak show songs. Good thing my skin is pale enough to pass the decomposing cold. Frozen in my thoughts, laying still, playing with people's emotions the way they kiss. Praying lips that I hate by fists. She didn't show, although she sent the card with eyes. How considerate that little bitch would make me sit in the car. Hours, my patience. It gets violent, break the flight. It seems like I quit. They didn't hear, they keep quiet, biting my tongue. Just excited that some kids were invited to come here. I'm the center of attention, the talk of the town. It ain't all that profound, but on this special day of mine, I'm the one the universe revolves around. Like a birthday, kind of. I also found that it's the worst way to find love. White dogs battle black clothes in one of the back rows. And everybody my ass knows back home is sporting black clothes. Looking glum as usual, it's all too familiar. Put the fun back into funeral, my morbid humor will kill you. For all that it's worth, the people I thought were judged for putting on the waterworks and it sort of hurts. My mama struck my head with so much care I hardly spoke. And now my heart is broken, yeah, I should have let her in on the joke. But I'm honestly troubled, and I'm stuck holding back my tears. As I absorb the atmosphere, I wanna come back, I'm scared. Then a hand touches my shoulder to calm my nerves. And something odd occurs because I heard my father's words. I got disturbed, so I expressed what he never said.
What bothered me most is I remembered she's dead. I manifested destiny, the best and worst of worlds has come true. As I'm buried alive, in the back of my mind, the ghost of his words, I love you.
That's some song, Igor.
Yeah.
It's a little bit macabre.
Yeah, it's a bit macabre.
It's a bit macabre. Hey, listen, so we're thinking maybe of you coming in like a month or so.
Yeah.
For like an hour or so of the show.
Yeah. Okay.
Could you do that?
Yeah.
Could you bring like a little keyboard with you?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, let's talk about it at some point.
Well, I was thinking, you know, why don't you try and get, you know, you had like 12 people online.
Yeah.
Say you had like a sing-along with like American Pie, and like each caller probably knows, you know, it'd be kind of a...
Yeah.
Radio happening.
12 people singing. Is that a good... Enough people know that song?
I think every caller would know it.
I don't know if
you suddenly put out call, you know, who can do chorus.
Yeah.
Then we build up to it, you know.
Yeah.
There's probably like Chubby Vicky, you know.
Okay. Barry. Well, I need to learn... Because I don't know how to do that. Because Chris needs to teach me how to do a conference call on here. Mm. But we can maybe have a go at that next week.
Okay.
Nice one.
All right.
Cheers, fella.
Bye-bye.
Take care. Lots of love.
See ya.
Bye-bye. Everyone's been really nice tonight. I'm confused by this. Let's have a little look. See what we've... let's have this one. Line... Oh, no, press that button there. This touch screen, I can't quite understand. Do I need... Oh, let's go there. Can we get rid of... Gary, can we get rid of that? Lovely. Thank you, mate. Cheers. There we go.
Harder.
Chris. No, right, let me... Okay, let's go there. Oh, no, I know what's right. I can do it. I just got to root it. Stay there. Line 5, you're on the wireless.
Hello.
Hello.
This is Greeky Lion.
Hello, Greeky Lion.
How are you? I wanted to play a piece of music called Light and Easy, but original, not like that guy Igor who keeps pirating people's stuff and he can't even bloody rap properly.
Kuklamu.
Kuklamu. Yes, Kuklamu. How are you?
Kuklamu. Very well, Kuklamu.
I didn't know you know Greek as well.
I know all the languages in the world.
Right, Ian Lee, you like Greeky Lion then?
Oh, I like Greeky Lion.
Yeah. All right, do you want me to play a little bit of this Life Ain't Easy?
Greeky Lion, can you stay there and play it after this ad?
Yeah, of course I can.
Thank you, sir.
All right, Ian Lee.
Party season's in.
New to Sunday nights. It's 3 hours of your calls going straight to air. It's the last hour already. It's his phone by. Chris is in the studio. Hello, Adrian. Chris.
Hi.
Normally he would be on the other side of the screen monitoring the calls and screening them. He's not doing that this evening, hence he's here. We're watching a film on BBC Two. It looks quite good. There was a good band playing there. Who's that? Is that... who's it? He's Jeff Daniels.
Jeff Daniels.
Who's that girl? She's quite saucy.
Oh, the one that's married to Antonio Banderas.
Huggy Bear. That's Antonio Fargas.
Yeah,
Molly Ringwald.
Molly, no.
Meg Ryan. Is it Meg Ryan?
Jane Seymour. No.
Anyway, well, so we're taking a call straight to air. 08709090973. Adrian Allen coming on at 1 o'clock, which will be nice. Let's have a quick run through these, shall we? Let's go. Line one, you're on the wireless.
I'd like to raise 3 points that have been missed in the debate so far.
Yes?
Firstly, why have they taken that wonderful man Mike Dickon off the air and replaced him with you?
Okay. I think you're listening. You're thinking of Talk Sports.
What? Who?
You're thinking of the radio station Talk Sports. This is LBC 97.3.
97.3?
LBC. London's LBC.
London?
It's LBC.
The second point is...
Yes.
Your hatred for Steve Allen is just repressed love for him.
Could be.
I think so.
Could be.
And thirdly, you... Love, TV ballet.
There we go. Bless you.
Thank you.
Bye bye.
Ciao.
Lovely. Oh, nice. There we go. We've got one. Let's go to line two. Line two, you're on the wireless.
Hello, Ian. It's Kerry.
Hello, Kerry. They're on foot. My first girlfriend was called Kerry. I have a very soft spot for that name.
Oh, good, good, good. I sent you the email.
Ooh, oh, was that? Oh, is that your foot? You're not interested in anything I have to say?
No, it wasn't me. It was about the band playing a hybrid.
Oh, that one! Okay. This, I've just had another email from another Kerry. Isn't that odd? Two Kerrys in one evening.
No, it wasn't. No. No.
Okay. You met Roger Daltrey's?
Yeah, we recorded the record that we played.
But he wrote it. Let's be honest, he didn't write any of the hits for The Who.
Well, he was a good singer.
He was a good singer. He's 64 years old.
I know. And,
he looks amazing.
I know, and he's such a nice guy.
Oh, I bet he is. I bet he is. The Who, you know, the Who, we love him.
What I was going to say to you is that I took some photos, and you know you can record a bit of video on your camera.
This is the rumour that's going around, yes.
Sarcastic.
No, not me.
Well, look. I've got, do you want me to play you a bit?
Yeah, okay. Wow, sounds good.
Oh, that's brilliant.
It's good.
Oh, you're sodding about, aren't you?
Yeah, I'm sodding about a bit.
You can't, because this is serious, and it was a major achievement today.
Okay, well, let's hear a clip of it. Oh, it sounds good! Mm. Sounds good.
Do you want me to do it? Because I'm not going to do it if you're not going to be...
Do it one more time. Oh, it sounds good.
That's good.
Sounds good.
Right, I'm not going to do it then.
Go on, play us a clip.
You have to wait till you buy it.
Go on, play us a clip.
And if you ask nicely.
Please, would you play us a clip?
This is Roger Daltrey singing, okay?
Sounds good.
Brilliant.
It does sound good. Well, that's not
wow.
He's
moved on.
He's moved on.
There you are.
Thank you, Kerry. Sounds good. Sounds good.
Very good.
Thank you.
Hello.
Hello.
You're still there?
Yeah, we're just saying it sounded good, thank you. We're thanking you.
Oh, good. Did you see any of the footage today?
I didn't, but Chris did.
Oh, okay. Well, it's going to be all on the Arsenal website tomorrow.
Excellent.
So, check it out, and please sign the guest book, because the kids will listen to you.
Okay, can you send me an email tomorrow to remind me?
Yeah, no worries.
Bless you, thank you.
Thanks, Ian.
Bye, Kerry.
Bye.
Can we listen to that song one more time? Yeah, I've got recorded it. Here we go. Hang on. Well, that was line two, wasn't it? Line three, you're on the wireless.
Oh, hi, it's Bill in Leyton.
Hello, Bill.
How are you, mate?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Oh,
all the regulars are sounding really tired and miserable.
it's very, very... I've got a headache.
I've had a headache for 7 days.
Have you?
I'm going to the doctor's, in 11 hours.
Yeah, oh, I just phoned up to say, Mike Dickens an idiot.
Yeah.
And, James Well, he's,
Could you... Bill, you could... Sorry. You couldn't sing this for me, could you?
Yeah, why not?
Away you go.
Mike Dickin is a boring, repetitive old man, and James Well is a Clive Ball ripoff, and Mike Mendoza, we should douse him in flames. Yeah.
Wow.
I'm about to say, we don't condone the dousing in flames of Mike Mendoza. again, thanks to Lino for sending in another picture here of Lucy Pinder this time, which is good. You gone, Bill? He's gone there.
Wow.
I think he's actually...
We don't condone any of that.
No, we don't we condone all of it, apart from the dowsing Mike Mendoza off in flames. Hang on a second. 0870-90-90-973 is the telephone number. That's a present for you, Chris. Was that three? Let's go to line four in that case. Line four, you're on the wireless! Hello, line four.
Hello?
Hello?
Hello. How's it going, mate?
Yeah, it's going all right, thank you.
It's Adam from Burnt Oak.
Hello, Adam.
I'm the noise correspondent.
Ah.
I'm so sorry, I've been quite absent.
You have been absent recently.
Yeah, hang on, let me turn away. So I was wondering, I would take this opportunity to do what I do best.
Yes.
And?
Play 5 to 10 seconds of noise.
Well, maybe a bit more, because, you know, it's not really, it's out of correspondent hours, isn't it?
Chris making a noise there. Okay, well listen, here comes the stab. When you hear it, away you go. You ready?
Righto. Hello?
Hello?
Yeah, how was that?
That was brilliant, thank you.
Sorry, thanks. Hey, do you know what?
Yes.
I think you should bring back spontaneous correspondent updates.
The spontaneous ones?
Yeah.
Do you reckon?
Yeah, I do.
Oh, well,
I find it tough to, like, you know, catch you at 5:38 all the time.
Well, the thing is, you can phone in before that and book your place.
I know, but the thing is, I'm not always in when you phone me back. Really busy.
Yeah, the thing is, the people like the regularity of the 5:38.
It's always the same, like, three people as well, though, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, there's an element of that.
Hey, I'm just going to say, I'm a big fan of Bill in Leighton. The guy's amazing.
He's great, isn't he? I don't know why he put the phone down then. I was hoping to chat to him for a bit, but he bottled it, I think. He's a bottler.
He's so funny, man.
He's a good singer.
I haven't heard him, like, do any correspondent up there.
No. I don't think he's a correspondent, is he?
Yeah, he is. He's the singing wrestling correspondent or something, right?
No, he's not the singing wrestling one. That's someone else.
You sure?
Oh, I've got to have a look on the website now. Hang on a minute. If you don't know what we're talking about, well...
You've got two wrestling correspondents, haven't you?
Yeah, well, the singing one never phones in, but I don't think he is the singing one. Hang on. Let me go to the page. I was saying the other day, because the non-singing one phones in quite a lot.
Yeah, all the time.
But, correspondence. Where is it right down?
I'm really glad that you're back on at this time.
Oh, it's Bill in the Leighton, it's the singing one.
Yeah.
I didn't realise. Oh, well, yeah, that's annoying. I think he's got a job now. That's a terrifying thought, isn't it? Do you know what? It's been fun this evening, and it's worked better than I thought it would.
It's really good, man.
Bless you, you're a good fella.
Thank you very much.
Cheers, mate, thanks a lot.
Take care, bye-bye.
That was line four, so therefore we have to go to line five. Line five, you're on the wireless.
Hi, how you doing?
Yeah, very well.
Good. I wanted to issue a warning to all the Barca players, because...
All the players?
The Barcelona players.
Oh, the Barcelona players.
Yeah, because I reckon that Arsene Wenger has been fishing around in Spurs kitchens today.
I'm sure he hasn't been at all. I'm sure he hasn't.
All the Spurs players were poisoned today.
Well, no, so seven of the Spurs players had food poisoning.
It's a bit coincidental, don't you think?
Yeah, it's a coincidence.
Yeah, it's not coincidence. I think Arsene Wenger.
No, we can't say that on the radio. No. I'm sure Arsene Wenger had nothing to do with it at all. I'm sure it's just one of those things. These things happen. It'll be exciting if there was foul play involved. I reckon there isn't. I'm sure it's just one of those things. And you can't go around saying things like that. It's very, very naughty, and of course that's not true. Line six is on the wireless.
Hi, Ian.
Hello, mate.
What's happening?
I'm fine. Everyone's sounding so... Why is everyone sounding so tired?
Ian, man, you know what I mean? It's a bit different from the afternoon, you know what I'm saying?
It is a little. It is a 12:15 on a Sunday.
Yeah, but you're saying everyone sounds a bit quiet, yeah? But what about you, man? You're not the hyper Ian at 3 to 6:30 in the afternoon.
Well, it's a different show, isn't it, I suppose?
I know. I'm expecting everyone to get a bit crazy, but I suppose at that time everyone's a bit high different, yeah. You know?
But, you know, I think it's good. People are still a little bit unsure as to what they can do and what they can get away with on this.
Absolutely.
So come back in 6 weeks and it'll be cracking. I think it's been good for the first night.
I mean, I'm quite looking forward to this evening as well, you know what I mean?
Have you been disappointed by it?
I'm not, you know. I mean, like you said, everyone's just obviously, you know, trying to get into the mix of things.
Seriously, man, come back in 6 weeks and it'll either be dead in the water or it'll be a cracking show.
Nah, I reckon it will, because that's how your show at 6:30 started, and everyone started to, like, hate at first, and now they're all, like, revoking all of their mad letters that they wrote in,
revoking. We haven't been revoking for a long time. They are revoking their mad letters that they wrote in. It's very true.
Yeah, you know what I mean? So it's all good, eh? You're not sleeping yet. I'm taking in your show, man.
Bless you, man. It's very kind.
No doubt, man. No doubt.
Everyone's been too nice tonight. No one has phoned in and said, we'll bring back Steve Allen, you're rubbish, you're... We've had none of that, which is a shame.
Nah, for real. Vicky, holler at Mario from Wilsdon, man. Anyway, you know what I mean, Ian? Good night.
I think I do. Take care.
Hello.
Bye, Mario. Yeah. Everyone's been too nice. We'll have a break in a second, so we'll leave the phone calls for a minute. 08709090973 is the phone number. If you want to give us a call, you can email ian@lbc.co.uk. I'll give out these MySpace things one more time. My one is myspace.com/ the real Ian Lee. And Chris is the real Agent Chris. And if you go to my top 8 friends, he's number 1, Agent Chris, with a picture that says Lapland Safaris. If you click on that, you can become his friend. I've got 228 friends.
I think I still got 99.
Well, shame on you. We'll do more of your calls after this.
You know, as we get older, things are...
Straight to Airline 7 just bottled it. Let's wait for that to fill up.
Bottler.
Again. There we go. Line 7, you're on the wireless.
Call me. 0208-133-43.
I don't know what phone number you're giving out there, so we'll stop that. I don't know, it could have been a radio station, which is fine, or it could have been
personal number.
So we'll stop that. I don't think that's a good thing to do. Line 8, you're on the wireless.
Yeah, hi, Ian.
Hi.
I was ringing up, I was a bit concerned.
Okay.
You had a creep on the radio there earlier.
Yes, we've had a few.
You had one complete freak. I hope you reported him to the authorities.
Which freak in particular do you
refer? Oh, I'm not going to mention the freak. The freak. Everybody who's listening knows who the freak was. They put us off the show.
Okay.
Okay? So you ain't got your regular callers no more because he put us off the show. What a freak.
Okay, that's a show. I do apologise.
So, Ian, you take care.
Thank you.
Love you, baby.
Love you, baby. I'm very concerned by that call.
I don't understand.
Line 9, you're on the wireless.
Oh, hi there, Ian. Yeah, glad you're back on air on Sundays.
We're on in the week, by the way. Does anyone know this? We're on Monday to Friday,
yeah,
3 to 6.30.
Yeah, I work, and, you know, I don't finish work until about 7, so...
Damn these jobs.
But, you know, like, have you got a Life Journal or Blogger account as well as MySpace?
No.
All right.
I've just got MySpace, and we just discovered it last week, and it's very, very addictive.
Right, okay, well, hopefully I'll get into it as well. But also, I noticed it said that Agent Chris went to Lapland on the Lapland Safari.
Yes, I went with him. I'm turning this down now, Chris.
Oh, right. Thank you.
You've had it hot for a while, we're getting it cold now. We both went.
So it's in Rethynemi, was it? The town of Rethynemi?
Yeah, it was.
I
went on that.
It's good, isn't it? Did you meet Father Christmas?
No, I didn't. Well, no. I met Father Christmas on a separate trip in the summer. It was about 30 degrees in 2003. That was quite amazing.
Yeah, he's a nice man.
What did you do in Lapland?
I went just mainly snowmobiling and...
We did snowmobiling, didn't we? It was wicked.
It was brilliant.
Yeah. Absolutely wicked.
Yeah, it's amazing going over the lakes because they're so bumpy.
Yeah, bumpy lakes.
With the ice.
Yes, so you be careful.
Yeah, and why is there an extra I in your name, by the way?
Because, it's vaguely Scottish.
Oh, okay.
And if you go back far enough, there's some Scottish blood in me.
Oh, cool.
Yeah. And it's the right way to spell it.
That is the proper way.
Such a boring name, Ian. I hate the name Ian.
Yeah.
It's three vowels and one soft letter, one soft consonant.
It.
Yeah, it's not good, it's not good.
Maybe you can persuade, other Ians, the boring Ians, to, change their... IA, the IAN to IA, what? IN.
Huh?
You ought to get all the ordinary Ians to, add an I to their name.
Adrian Allen to do what?
No, get the ordinary Ians to add an
I. Well, I think he's coming in about 20 minutes, isn't he?
Oh.
Is Adrian Allen coming in 20 minutes, Chris?
I think so.
Oh, right. Does he have an extra I in his name?
I think he's just one of the Adrian Allens.
Right. Maybe it could be Adrian. Do you see what I mean? You know, there's an Ian at the end of Adrian.
Well, that's the rumour going around this building, and whoever is spreading that rumour, I want you to stop it now!
Okay, sorry.
That's okay.
I'll speak to you soon.
Take care, thank you for calling.
Okay, thanks.
Lots of love, bye-bye. Whoever is spreading this rumour about there being an Ian at the end of Adrian, Alan, just stop it. Because it's upsetting my family, all right?
It's nasty.
It's nasty.
10.
Like 10, you're on the wireless!
Flippin' heck, Tucker! Oh, I've been on this phone for so long.
He said Tucker.
He said flippin' heck.
Yes. Go on.
Do you know why everyone's so laid back when they're on the phone to you? Like
they're smoking marijuana.
No, because I have to wait so goddamn long.
Well, we're getting more calls than we thought we'd get. All of the lines are busy.
Have you got the same amount of lines as you do in your daytime show?
Yes.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, this is really successful. I think you might get sacked from your daytime show and just get put on the evening.
Do you know what? That's the plan, but don't tell anybody, all right?
Well, do you like the evenings, then, yeah?
Yeah, I do like the evenings.
Well, I had the sniffles anyway, and I've not heard anyone talk about those.
I'm going to the doctor's at 11.
What happened to your Saturday appointment at the, walk-in centre?
Bottled it.
So, are you feeling better or what?
I feel really bad. I feel a bit better. I'm alright. I've taken these decongestant tablets from the chemist. Man, it was like, taking acid, from what I hear. It literally blew my mind. I stopped taking them, because I was really spaced out.
I actually took some when I went on a diving course in Total in
Thailand. Acid?
No, some decongestant.
Decongestant, sorry, yes.
I didn't take that, because if you go down...
On a diving course?
Get to breathe. Yeah, and I got reverse block, which actually blew my nose out, and I was sniffing that red snot for about 3 months. But that's by the by.
That sounds awful.
It was terrible, because when you're in Thailand, you just get given loads of antibiotics to clear it up, and all I needed to do was just to, breathe properly. But anyhow, I'd like you to know that my garden furniture show this weekend went very well, thanks to your bit of free advertising that you did for me.
Your
free furniture is on the way, because that was our deal.
Thank you.
Won't tell anyone.
By the way, I've got a memory of you on Rise.
Yes.
Because someone was saying that you wasn't very good. Wait, you always used to kick that girl under the table. Remember?
What, Kate?
Yeah, and one time she actually screamed out loud and nearly started crying, and there was a bit of an atmosphere going on towards the end of the series.
I don't remember making her cry.
Well, she was very upset. She shouted her out, that really hurt, and then there was like a 5-second pause.
Well, it serves her right for being stupid, doesn't it?
Well, definitely, yeah. Well, I haven't heard any, like, rude words. Not that I expect them or aren't going to give them, but I've not heard
No, nor have I. It's been very good so far.
Yeah.
Well, we'll see how that goes.
Well, I'm not gonna use any anyway.
No.
But, if you could say near Queen Heaven, would that be a rude word?
What?
Near Queen Heaven.
I'm probably missing something there, so we won't say it again.
Yeah.
But if you reverse it, then you kind of get the word, but there you go. Anyway, no, it's great to hear you. I've been sitting here trying to speak to you for an hour, and I've completely lost the plot of what I was talking about. But good show, and I hope you're on for the next few weeks at least.
Near Queen Heaven.
Yeah, just reverse it, and then you've got it. It's what someone said to me once.
Heaven.
Opposite of near.
Oh.
Married to a king.
Oh, okay, yes, far. Okay. Yeah, well done. Okay, thank you.
Okay, sorry.
Thank you. No, that's quite all right. Well done.
Right. I'm still waiting for that guy to ring back with another joke, by the way.
Yes. Yes.
It was a classic.
Yes, it was a good joke, wasn't it?
Three guys walked into a bar and...
He got a little bit nervous, I think.
I think he did. Okay, well, let's hope that he rings back before the end of the night, because I don't think I'll be up to sleep without a good punchline.
Well, we'll see what happens. Thanks very much for calling.
Cheers, mate.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Line six, you're on the... Oh, no. Line six, you're on the wireless.
All of which makes me anxious. At times, unbearably so.
14 seconds. Thank you, my friend. Okay, let's up the pace a bit now. Line one, you're on the wireless.
Hello, mate. I had a dream last night that me and Adrian Allen, we was in a pub and we saw my dick and threw a pint of beer on him.
That's unbelievable.
This is doing related again, mate.
Yeah.
I thought because I bottled it last time and phoned back up, like.
Oh, but you bottled it, and this is you in your real voice now.
I am a Geordie,
Are you phoning back?
I also had a dream that I threw a dog poo at him as well.
Well, there you go. Are you phoning back because someone said they were a big fan of yours?
Yeah.
Of course you are, you Muppet.
Muppet. And I'm just phoning to say I'll do a correspondent report tomorrow.
Yeah, your correspondent has been noted that you've not been calling in. What?
Yeah, well, I was waiting to have some good material.
Well, the other guy's been calling in all the time.
Well, maybe he needs to go out more.
Well, maybe you need to call in more.
Yeah, I could do, but do you think it's worrying I've had dreams about throwing dog poo at my dick in?
It's not worrying, it's just very sexy.
But it's just, I don't like him, he's boring and he's...
You don't need to listen to him anymore. Hopefully Nick Abbott will be back next week, or soon anyway, on Saturdays. I'll be doing Sundays, and everything's fine and groovy.
But the thing is, I listened to him for 5 minutes because you always used to slate him, and then... Yeah. I thought, no wonder you slay him, because he's just...
I'm Mike Dickin! I'm Mike Dickin! That woman has had a baby!
Do you know what? He's like one of them turds, he just won't go down. No matter how many times you flush him, he just won't go down.
Bless him. Phil, thank you!
Bye.
Bye. Alright, this could be a disaster. Let's try line three. Line three, you're on the wireless. Bottle it. Absolute bottler.
Bottler.
Line nine, don't be a bottler.
Be a winner.
Come on.
Hello,
be a winner, not a bottler.
Hello. Hello, this is MC Teleboy Kai speaking.
Yes. Turn your radio off, it might be easier.
I'm calling my girlfriend.
Turn your radio off.
I just got in, I found your number in her phone. Are you stupid? Asia. Are you stupid? How can you do this? Okay, I will find you. I know you.
Was that a threat?
I think that was a threat.
He threatened me, then he bottled it.
Do you feel threatened?
I feel very threatened. Line nine, you're on the wireless.
Sugar, yum, yum. Hello, Ian.
Hello.
David Hackney.
Hello, David the Hackney! We don't get to speak very often.
I know, I've been so busy. Oh, gosh. But, I'll catch up, you don't worry.
I've got something for you.
Yes?
Dick. 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 Mario, what made you ring? Good girl. Dick. Hash.
Any good?
Oh, give me some more. One more.
Well, hang on. This is for you. Okay, you ready?
Yeah.
Flange. Yeah. Flange.
You love Anna Rayburn?
I love Anna Rayburn.
Why do you love her so much?
I don't know. I've got some strange fetish about her. I might have some nasty dream about her tonight.
Flange. Dick.
Nasty dream about her.
Hash.
That's upset me. Oh dear. There's you, Dave.
Yeah. Yes. Mike Dickin, he's such a rubbish presenter. I've listened to
I love it. People just phoning up to slag off Mike Dickin. Very funny. Yes.
Mike Dickin, Charlie Wolf, James, what his name is, James Wellen, James Gaunt, or what's his name?
John Gaunt, yes.
What a load of crap.
They aren't very good, are they?
No.
No, sir.
We need more of you, sir. We need more of you.
Good girl.
And more of Anna Rayburn, yeah.
A little blow never hurt anybody.
Definitely Anna Rayburn. That's what we're
on. Thanks for calling, Dave.
Okay.
Have a good one. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
He's one of the correspondents. He's the longest stuff correspondent. We don't get to chat to him very much, so that's very nice. I'm getting cold now.
Sounds like he's a fan of Anna Rayburn.
He's got a thing for Anna Rayburn. 870-9090-973. Okay, we're coming up to the last half an hour of the show. So when we get back, we're going to have a break. Then we'll be back for 20 seconds. Then we'll have some news. Then we'll come back. And then I think we should just rattle through them. It's been a little bit slower than I was expecting. So for the last half hour, we're just going to rattle through them. 870-9090-973.
Once upon a time, in a land far, far...
Line 10, you're on the wireless!
All of which makes me anxious.
Will this fit in? We have to go to a break at some point. Can't hold the news.
Fingers crossed.
Yeah, this could be a dream or it could be a nightmare. No, it's not going to work. It's not going to work.
At times, unbearably so.
Oh, you are a genius! These calls now as quickly as we can. Let's go to line number one. Line one, you're on the wireless.
Hi, Ian.
Hello.
It's Stanley from Alien. How you doing?
Very well, my friend.
Good. Ian, I've discovered something really nasty.
Yep.
You know, I live in Ealing, right?
Right, well, I didn't know.
I drive through A40 from, like, centre of the city.
Yes.
And every time I pass White City, which BBC is there,
yes.
I get this really bad interference. Basically, I cannot hear LBC whatsoever.
Are you saying that BBC is sabotaging our signal?
I think they are, yeah.
Sodom!
Yeah. I'm definitely sure. I've tried them for the past week.
Yeah.
I thought maybe there's something wrong with my radio. Why not? Every time I pass from White City to North Acton,
yeah.
I get this bad interference.
Unbelievable.
Yeah. Nasty people.
They are nasty! Especially that Vanessa Feltz.
Nasty people. Anyway, you have a good evening. I'll speak to you during the week.
Thank you. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Unbelievable. The BBC, they're being nasty. Let's try line two. Line two, you're... Oh, no, press the wrong button. Line two, you're on the wireless.
Chilblain?
I was referring to,
Chilblain?
There we go. Line ten, you're on the wireless.
Uh-oh, yeah. Uh-oh.
Bottled it. Line six, you're on the wireless.
Hello, Ian, it's Gary in the Germany here.
Hello, Gary. Oh, in Germany?
In the Germany.
Hello, mate, how are you doing?
Very well, and you?
Yeah, excellent stuff.
Super, it's great to have you back on a Sunday evening where you belong.
How is it sounding? Is it sounding all right? I mean, this is the first one, and we weren't expecting to get many calls, so it's better than I thought it would be, but it still needs a bit of work, but I think it's something. There's a nugget there.
Well, I would say 9.2 this evening.
Oh, that's not bad 9.2. Going. That'll do me.
Ian, would you like the chance to win €12,000 or a Mercedes sports car?
Yes.
Well, I'll pass you over to 9 Live, which is on the TV now.
Okay.
And if you pick the right word, you can win €12,000.
Wow. Okay, good luck.
Okay. Ja. Da kommt es hier um Auto, das ist €25,000 wert. Da muss man mit oberster Chef was anfangen.
Oberster Chef?
Ja, deswegen gehört das Auto auch nicht hier.
Fängt mit Bau an, logischerweise.
Do you understand that?
Hello?
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 So you have to pick a word that begins with bow, and you can win 12,000.
Bal. Balzac.
That'll do. I'll send you the cash by post.
It's simple as. Thank you, Gary.
Speak to you soon.
Cheers, mate. Bye-bye.
Bye now.
Not a clue. Not a clue. But I think by saying Balzac, I just won us 12,000 euros.
Hey, nice.
What's that? That's 97 pence. Line 5, you're on the wireless.
Hi, Ding Ian.
Yeah, very well.
Good. I have an apology to make.
Oh, okay. Away you go.
It's not really to you. It's to Danny, because I called out earlier, yeah, and I promised him I'd say hello to him.
Yeah.
I didn't say hello to him. So, say hello to him for me.
You have to what?
So, I'm saying hello to him now, basically.
Okay.
Okay, also,
Well, that's a hello, not an apology. Apology,
yeah, it was an apology for not saying hello before.
Okay. Chris, well, surely apology has to have the word sorry in, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, I said sorry for not apologising. Sorry for not saying hello before.
Why are you
apologising
to me, Chris? Why have you...
Oh, no, but I'm just saying the word sorry would be in an apology.
I'm so sorry to disturb your conversation.
Sorry?
Sorry to disturb your conversation.
No, I was apologising to Chris.
So we're having a massive apology session now.
I'm sorry, Chris.
Sorry, Ian.
I'm sorry.
And I said sorry to me for talking in my conversation.
Sorry?
Sorry.
Everyone, sorry.
Meow.
Good. Fine, Ian, I'll speak to you later.
Thank you.
See you, bye.
Not a clue. Not a clue, but that's the way I like it, baby. Who wants to live forever? Line 6, you're on the wireless.
Chili blames.
Well, there we go. We have a...
Chili blinds?
Love it.
You love it. We have a catchphrase developing, which is kind of nice. Let's go to this. This is a strange area code. Let's go to line 3. You're on the wireless.
Hi, Ian.
Hello.
Hi, it's Louise in Barnsley.
Hello, Louise in Barnsley.
Yeah.
This is cool.
You are, sorry?
This is cool. Why are you listening in Barnsley?
Because...
You live
there. I was looking through and, like, I've heard you a few times.
Where's Barnsley?
Barnsley's in South Yorkshire.
Yeah, it is.
Oh. It says so on my screen, that's how
north.
That is up north. Well, hey, so you're listening on the Sky television?
Yes, 0177.
That's the fella, well done.
Yes. Can I ask you something?
Of course.
Right, is this going to be, like, a regular thing, or...?
Well, we do the weekday shows, Monday to Friday.
Right.
3 to 6:30. But the Sunday show, for the moment, is going to be a regular thing, and we're going to see how it goes.
Oh, fantastic, because you feel funny.
No, that's very kind, and you
I'll be honest with you, I was expecting to hear someone else, but never mind.
Who were you expecting to hear?
I was expecting to hear Nick.
Ah, no, Nick, well, Nick's going to be doing Saturdays, but he's not very well at the moment.
Oh, bless him.
So he's taking a couple of weeks off.
Yeah.
But, fingers crossed, no, he's brilliant.
He is, he makes him laugh.
Yeah, he's good. But, oh, well, then, listen.
As you, though.
Hey, I make her laugh more than the Abbas. There we go.
Hey, nice one.
Well, that's...
Can I ask you something?
You can.
Have you done some voiceover work as well?
Yes.
For a certain Russian TV programme.
Sorry?
For a Russian TV programme.
For Russia, Extreme Russia, yes, that's me.
You made that show.
Well, you know, can I say, they paid me a stat load of money, I turned up and I did it. And it was made by a bloke who I used to work with a long time ago, so I was more than happy to do that.
Yeah. But it's good to hear you anyway.
It's good to hear you. Thank you for calling.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Very nice. This is confusing me. Line... Oh, I pressed one button. Line 7, you're on the wireless. Yes, I think we've been there, done that. That's very kind. Line 10, you're on the wireless.
Guess I got a wink off a lady.
I did. If I press this, does that then go...
If
there's one in there and I press another one...
As long as it's not red,
yeah,
it should just flick.
Okay, what does this... we've had this one before, haven't we? Yeah, we've had that. Let's go to, the line. One, you're on the wireless. Thanks very much. Line 4, you're on the wireless. This is Adrian Allen.
All of which makes me anxious.
Here we go. There's a pause. I've got really bad indigestion from that pizza.
Yeah, me too.
Give Adrian your seat. Come on, be a gentleman. Hey, man, how's it going?
Big lad. Very good.
We're that waiting one. For someone just to finish the sentence.
Yeah, that one.
There's a long pause.
At times unbearably.
There we go. He's done it. How's it going, man? Nice to meet you. Sorry.
Very good. How are you?
I saw you downstairs once and didn't realise it was you.
Really?
Yes.
Have a seat. Thank you very much, sir.
So
kind.
My memory is like golf.
I was listening to you the other day.
Oh yeah.
And some woman was saying that she loves you, loves you, loves you.
Yeah.
And reckons that Adrian Allen's a more mature version of you.
What was that all about? Someone was saying that, weren't they?
Yeah.
Well, that's a... Is that a compliment? You're mature, in terms of years, surely, compared to me.
You're too kind.
I'm 33 in a month. Jesus.
Yeah, well, mine's got a four in it somewhere.
That's
Christ.
That boy there... Chris, stand in the corner.
Hi.
Bless him, he's doing well. How you doing, sir? You all right?
Yeah, very good.
How are you enjoying the late night series? Is it all going well?
It's fantastic.
Lovely.
It's fantastic.
I've heard bits of it.
And the new show sounds really good this evening.
Hey, thanks very much. We've had more calls than we thought. It's kind of a gentle start, but it'll...
Sundays are cool.
Yeah, it's good, isn't it? We used to do the Friday, Saturday, Sunday slot. Yeah. And it's, you know, nighttime's kind of more fun.
It have its own ambiance.
And mental people.
Yes, its own ambiance was our...
The polite way of describing lunatics.
Yes.
What's happening on your show tonight?
We're going to go the gnome route. Do you know that gnomes are cool?
I did not
know that. They are cool.
I was unaware.
All the supermarkets are selling out of them.
Yeah.
They're all cool. You need to get some.
Here. These are garden gnomes.
Garden gnomes. And also, Kate Winslet is going to star in a midget version of Romeo and Juliet.
This is not true, is it?
Yeah, Romeo and Juliet.
No.
It's being backed by Sir Elton John.
Of course it is, because he's a gnome himself. My mum's got a gnome, and it's hard. I don't know why she's got it, but she loves it. And when you walk past it, it drops its trousers and farts.
No way.
Yeah.
Like a son.
Yeah. There you go, you see. It's all very good. That sounds cool.
So we're doing gnomes, we're also doing Iraq, so we're kind of going, you know, frivolous and heavy, frivolous and heavy, frivolous and heavy.
Very nice.
That's the kind of thing we
do. Excellent stuff. That's from 1 o'clock. And what time do you finish? Five?
Five. It's rock and roll.
That's a shift, man, isn't it?
No, it's not. It's easy.
Okay, cool.
It's easy.
Brilliant.
Coffee.
Yes. Oh no, I've had plenty. I'm going to bed in an hour, so I don't want any more coffee. That'll be cool.
Top man, yeah, you'll be back on.
Yeah.
In a few hours.
Yeah, bloody hell. Anyway, Adrian, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Nice to see you, sir.
And you, sir.
Okay, we've got 20 minutes of this then before Adrian pops in. So let us try and steam through these. I'm going to make it cold, Chris, because it keeps me awake.
No worries.
Let us steam through these now. Let's go line one. You're on the wireless. Here we go. What is this crap?
I kind of like it.
Is it blind?
Well, yes. I'm going to cut them off. Oh, they've just saved it.
There you go.
I'll cut them off now. No.
It's got to be green.
What has to be green?
There. That's it.
Okay. Oh, I see. Line 2, you're on the wireless.
Hello.
So I can't make that go green. Gary has to do that.
Yes. Hi,
okay. Hello, line 2.
Hi.
Hello.
How are you?
Good.
I was well impressed with your singing.
Thank you.
And this guy is playing that music, the Indian music.
Oh, it's good, isn't it?
And do you know that song that you sang? Do you know what it means?
Pardesi.
Yeah, sing it. Go on.
Pardesi, pardesi, jana nahi, mujhe chore ki, mujhe chore ki.
You know what that means?
Is it about going away or something?
Yeah, it's like he's come from another country.
Yeah.
He's fell in love with this woman, and she's saying, oh, please don't leave me now. Oh, traveller, please don't leave me.
Don't leave me.
Janjani janardam badabadam pam 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 pam. Do you know any other songs?
Doom-mera-doom-mera-doom-mera-doom-mera-doom-mera, hero number one. That's all I know.
Oh, my God.
I need to learn some more. Good, huh?
Okay.
Lovely.
Good. Well, good show, by the way.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, and the other thing is...
Yes?
Can you not put a zap on those calls that you get, like, people swearing? I think it's terrible.
But I don't think we've had any swearing, have we?
Yeah, I'm not going to repeat it, obviously.
What swearing did we have?
You know, like the pop-ups you get on the computer. Can't
yes.
You delete them?
Do we have, we've not had any swearing tonight, have we?
I haven't heard anything.
We did, an hour ago.
What was it?
I'm not saying.
Hint at it. Hint at it.
He was swearing.
Saying what? F-word? Yes?
Yeah.
F-word. I don't think it was the F-word. I think we were a bit overcautious. I think it was fight. I want to fight you. I think he said, I want to fight you, and we all...
But how dare you say that, anyway? Basel. Say to him, Basel.
Basel.
Basel means mad.
Here.
Madman.
I'm trying to think if I know any more. I can count, but I don't think I can do that anymore.
Oh, okay, go on, then try.
Yeah, try.
Chapan... What's one?
Ik.
Ikti chapan...
Do, tin, chas, pan, che, sat, art. No.
No das! Sarah no das! Of course, yes.
Yeah.
Ikti, chapan. I can't remember it very well.
Okay.
But never mind.
All right, great show.
Thank you!
Thank you.
Bye-bye!
Bye.
Let's go to line number 3, you're on the wireless. have this. Thank you. That's the Alphabet Business Concern. Will mean nothing to most people, but to me, it is beautiful. Thank you for that, whoever you are. I think I know, but I'm not sure. Line four, you're on the wireless.
Hello, guys.
Gays?
Guys.
Oh, hello.
How are you? It's Jackie from the South Mid.
Hello, Jackie from the South Mid. Chris, how are you?
I'm fine. How
it's
are you?
Jackie from
hey,
the South.
Jackie.
Hey, Jackie.
Hi, guys. How are you?
Gays?
Brilliant, guys. Brilliant night.
Gays?
Guys.
Gays
you're
or guys?
Not gay, you're real men.
Gay in the soldier.
What?
You're men's men.
Well, no, those are gays.
No, you're not gay.
Gays are men's men.
Well, you might be gay, I don't know.
You can tell by the way I use my walk, I'm a woman's man. No time for talk. I got a good voice.
Gay in the soldier.
Yes. So, Jackie, I have to go to a break.
Okay, but just to say it's been a great evening.
Thank you.
I'll be listening next week.
Please do.
Take care, guys.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye.
Ah, Mr. Michaels, I've examined your cat.
So we've been taking your calls to air for 3 hours, which we're going to do every Sunday night from 10 o'clock. But apparently people don't know that I do a show Monday to Friday, 3 till 6.30 in the afternoon.
You sure do?
Well, I do, yes, and Adrian Crisp produces it. But we're here every Sunday night at 10 till 1 for the next couple of months. And let's go see. OK, let's steam through these. Let's go to line 9. Line 9, you're on the wireless.
Yo, this is Ian Lee on the wireless 97.3. He's got a new show, Sundays, 1 a.m. I give you tonight about a 6 out of 10. He thinks he's funny, his jokes are cool, but he ain't got nothing on that legend, Clive Boone. Yeah, Boone. How'd you like that one, baby?
Yes.
Yeah, you like it?
You're right as well, Clive is the governor.
Nah, I do like you better, to be honest.
Well, then why didn't you say that in your rap, then? Well, your rap should be about truth and honesty, and you're just doing it because it rhymes.
Yeah, that's the only reason, you know. I just turned on and I thought, I've got 5 minutes.
Shame on you. Shame on you.
What rhymed with...
Shame on you. Put the phone down.
No, man.
Shame on you. Put the phone down.
All right, well, I'll give you a better one tomorrow, yeah?
One that tells the truth.
Okay, yeah, sure.
Bye-bye.
See you later.
Shame on you. Shameful, indeed. Line 7, you're on the wireless. Sweetly! I like comedy with jokes in. Line 8, you're on the wireless.
Hello.
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 Hello there.
Hello.
Got really bad indigestion from that coffee.
Yeah.
And that pizza. The combination of coffee and pizza has given me... My chest isn't as tight as it was. Could you feel my... No. Yes?
Hello.
Hello there.
Nigel here.
Hello, Nigel. This is going to be rubbish, but we'll carry on for a second.
Huh?
You got 10 seconds, Nigel.
10, 9.
And that's your time up. That was absolutely awful. Awful.
Rubbish.
Worst one we've ever had. Line 6, you're on the wireless. What's this? This is good.
Time again.
It's good. I can't really hear it. Thanks very much. I'm going to start cutting people off now because we're getting towards the end, so let's crack on. Line 9, you're on the wireless.
Hi. Ian, could you quickly say hello to my friend Margaret? She listens to you, like, nearly every day, and I just phoned her about an hour ago to tell her you was on, so could you please say hello to her?
Hello, Margaret.
Okay, thank you.
Bye-bye. Line 10, you're on the wireless.
Hello.
Hello?
Hello. Quick song. It goes... Galileo, 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 Galileo invented the telescope and was persecuted by the Roman Catholics and died of penicillin.
Thank you. Shame we missed out on the end.
I haven't heard that song.
No, I've not heard that song. Did Queen not do that? Was that not a Queen song?
I think they covered it.
Yeah, maybe they did. Maybe they did. Let's try line 6. Line 6, you're on the wireless. Well, there you go, you see. We've almost got ourselves... a catchphrase, which is something I think you've got to be proud of.
You're blind?
Yeah, we go. Line 5, you're on the wireless.
Oh, sorry. I was watching Superbikes. Miles away. Just a quick question.
Watching Superbikes?
Yes.
You're blind?
Wow.
Oh, I love the Superbikes. There's something about a man in leather with a big shiny helmet.
Okay, yeah, we know you mean a penis there, but well done. Let's carry on. Let's brush over that one.
No, I was just wondering, I'm a new caller, by the way, my name's Claire.
So?
I was just wondering, what does Agent Chris look like?
Asian Chris looks like me.
Oh, not too bad, then.
Hey, not too bad. No, not too bad. It's like a younger, better-looking version of me.
You've got a lovely voice, but there's something about Agent Chris's voice.
Well, Chris, please talk to this horrible old woman.
Well, what do you want to know?
I just wanted to know what you look like.
Describe yourself to the lady.
Yeah, basically what Ian says, I'm just look like a much, much younger version of him.
Ooh. I could go for a bit of that.
Really? What do you look like?
I'm half Irish, and people say that I look a slightly bit like the Calls, me and my three older sisters.
The bloke?
No! Goodness, no! I'm very attractive, thank you.
Could you send in a picture for Adrian Crisp?
I could do, yes, but I haven't got access to the internet at the moment. It's broken.
How convenient.
No, honestly. I'm 21. And very good looking.
Yeah, that's why you're phoning up a radio station at 10 to 1 in the morning.
I can't sleep.
No, of course you can't.
And I want to watch Troy Bayliss.
Who?
Super Bayliss?
Troy Bayliss.
Troy Bayliss?
Yeah, he's an Australian. He's absolutely brilliant.
Okay, you sound like a nutter.
I'm not a nutter, I promise.
Go to sleep now.
She's fallen in love with you.
Are you going to cut me off?
Not just yet, but in a minute.
Oh, because I've been trying to read.
Oh, no, in fact, I'm going to do it now. Sorry. Sorry, Chris. I know you were getting it on there, but it's, you know, I'm in the room. It's embarrassing. Line 7, you're on the wireless.
Ian, how you doing?
Yeah, very well, thank you.
Good. We had a bit of a surreal conversation before.
You had a what?
We had a bit of a surreal conversation before.
Did we about what?
About I'm sorry and you're sorry and he's sorry and Ian and.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, that was the apology. So as soon as I finished my apology conversation, yes, I got about 50 million texts saying, why didn't you say sorry to me for not saying hello to me? And why didn't you say hi? Yep, so everyone annoys me for not saying sorry for not saying hello to them. So I told them I'll call up again and I'll say hello to all of them.
But again, your apology is the same thing. Your apology
I'm not apologising. I'm not apologising.
Well, you should be.
No, before we apologised, we've done the apologies.
But you've got to apologise for not saying sorry to them.
We've done the apologies.
Okay.
Okay, I'm very sorry to everyone who, if I didn't tell it to.
So you are saying sorry, that you are apologising.
He's apologising.
And he said sorry this time.
He used the word sorry. Sorry.
Okay, well, I'm glad
I
to
apologise. Also, I learned my lesson from last time.
Yeah.
And that's why I...
Well, I'm sorry if we bullied you last time.
I forgive you this time.
I'm sorry, Chris.
For last time.
For making you touch me.
I'm sorry I'm here.
I'm sorry, you're sorry.
Hello, sorry. Anyway... Also, yeah, so basically, can you say hi to Ellie?
No, I'm not saying hello to anyone else. Chris, you can say hello to this Ali fella.
No, we've had too many shout-outs.
Yeah, we're not doing shout-outs.
You don't have to do any shout-outs.
No shout-outs.
Fine.
So, thank you.
Have a wonderful evening.
Bye-bye.
So, yeah, and say hi to Danny. Danny, hi, Danny.
Go away.
Bye.
Put your phone down.
Bye.
There you go, he's gone. This is good. Line 4. Line 4, you're on the wireless.
Hello, is that Mike Lee?
Yes, it is.
Oh, it took me a whole hour to get through.
What do you think about that woman having a baby at the age of 63?
I think it's, I'm completely against it. It's against nature as well. And, you know, I'm totally against it. But, as far as Mike Dickin is concerned, I think he's the best thing since Cornish pastry. Or Cornish pasty, I should say. And, as far as the, BAFTAs are concerned, I don't think Life on Mars got one, did they? I don't think they got an award.
I don't think... Well, Life on Mars was rubbish.
Well, a lot of people say it's good. I found it very good.
It's rubbish. What, John Sim goes back to 1973, but only in his mind?
Hmm. It was something different, you know, quite original.
No, it was rubbish. It was as rubbish as the weather forecasts on this station.
Yeah, and,
bloody weather forecasts!
And finally, do you know how Marcus Churchill is?
He's hopefully coming back in July.
In July?
Fingers crossed, yes.
Okay, right. Thank you.
Thank you! It was, wasn't it?
It was, definitely.
It was, definitely was.
Well, there you are.
Wow, that suddenly made me feel very, very excited. I've never heard him phone in before.
No, no.
I wish we could... Oh, no, we can't. Let's not even hint at it. It's not fair. Line 1, you're on the wireless.
Ian, you realise it's almost 5 to 1 in the morning?
Yeah.
Do you know what the time is, LA time, at all?
There's 6 hours behind us, so I guess it's 5 to 1.
So I wonder what Mackenzie Crook, Ricky Gervais and Sacha Baron Cohen are doing at...
Well, Mackenzie will be at home in Muswell Hill.
Muswell Hill?
Yeah.
Not Hollywood?
No, he's just around the corner from me.
Oh, right, because I thought he's making it big in Hollywood at the moment.
No, he's just finished filming Pirates 2 and 3.
Oh, right, you're not in that at all, then?
No.
No, you haven't been courted by Steven Spielberg?
No, not at all, no.
Pictures?
No, 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 not at all.
No? You haven't written for The Simpsons at all?
No, never.
I wonder why that is.
Because they're all better than me.
They're better than you?
Yeah.
Oh, right, so it's self-depreciation time then.
No, it's self-deprecation is the word.
Oh, right, thanks for letting me know that.
That's okay.
Right,
if you're going to criticise someone, get the words right, okay?
Yeah, I will do.
Okay.
Okay, bye.
Bye-bye. Absolute twat.
When I grow up, I'm going to be a racing driver.
5 minutes of the show, let's really rattle through these. Line three, you're on the wireless.
Hello?
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 Hello there.
Hello, I'm Ali.
Hello, Ali.
You didn't want to give me a shout-out before.
Oh, no, we're not doing shout-outs.
Well, do a shout-out for me.
No?
Yes.
Sorry.
Give me a shout-out now.
Thank you. Line two, you're on the wireless. He's the wrong way around. This,
Hello?
Line two? Someone's snoring.
Someone's accidentally called in.
And fallen asleep. So we can wake them up. Hang on.
You're blind?
Wake up!
Cuckoo, cuckoo.
I love this show. All singing and dancing. Dancing and singing.
Well, let's leave them there and let's, No, let's leave that one up, Gary. Thank you. Let's, see what, We'll leave them. Maybe they'll wake up if they hear this. Line, four, you're on the wireless.
Hello?
Hello?
Hi.
Hello?
Hi.
Hi.
How are you doing?
Oh, hang on.
Oh, someone's staring.
No, he's back to sleep. Yeah, very well, thank you, line four. Are you going to say anything or should we move on?
I just want to say, if Kazim Zaidi's listening, she should be in bed like 6 o'clock.
Okay, I've got no idea what you're talking about, and, I can't be bothered to find out. Line, nine, you're on the wireless.
Guess he got a wink from a lady.
Yes, I did, and guess you got stack loads of money for saying that. Line seven, you're on the wireless.
Iranu.
Thank you.
Is line two still asleep?
Line two, are you still asleep? Yeah, I can just hear a faint snoring. Line three, you're on the wireless.
Oh, hello, Ian.
Hello.
You wanted somebody to kick off?
Yeah.
Well, we've left it a bit late now.
Well, never mind.
Well, when you first started, and I first started listening to LBC...
97.3.
Yeah, 97.3.
London's.
Okay, we've got a minute.
Yeah, well, your mother had a cat in a wardrobe.
Yes.
And I wrote you a long letter full of sympathy and help.
Yes.
And telling you about my cat, and
yes.
It was all fiction.
Yes. What's all fiction?
Was it a cat?
What cat?
In your mother's wardrobe.
Yes, she's still there. She was sick yesterday.
I'm sorry about that, but have you cut a sprout yet?
No, she comes out and eats and she goes back to the cupboard.
Well, she's safe there. Leave her. Did you get my letter?
Yes, thank you very much.
All right.
Thank you!
One more thing.
Oh, yes. It's not exactly the thunder.
On one of the occasions when we were listening, you were dead worried you were going to lose your car because you've been speeding. What happened?
I've kept my licence, I didn't get the points, I'm a good boy, I've got my mum's car now, which is good. I work in the week, why don't you listen to the week show?
I do sometimes.
But it's not very good.
Oh, it is, it is.
Listen, I've got to go, thank you very much for calling, thank you to everyone who's calling. Adrian's not here yet, so we can carry on. Oh, is he? Oh, he's bottled it. Adrian's bottled it, has he?
He's a bottler.
No, he's not a bottler, he's a lovely fellow. Listen, thank you very much for everyone who's called in. I will be back tomorrow at 3 o'clock. Monday, Friday, 3 to 6:30, and we'll be back next week, Saturday. Chris, did you enjoy yourself?
Yes.
You've had the cushiest night of your life.
I know.
You love it. Gary, thank you. Adrian, thank you very much, sir. See you later on. Have a good one. See you tomorrow at 3. Bye-bye.